military, they call the man with the flag the guidon bearer. And tonight, fittingly enough, it's Jake Kaufman as Northern Illinois takes the field on ESPN's College Football Primetime. An absolutely gorgeous night tonight in the land of Lincoln. And a huge clash in the MAC West. It's the Toledo Rockets taking on the Huskies of Northern Illinois. And both teams are undefeated in conference play. Whoever comes out of this game the winner tonight will be in the driver's seat for the division title with just two games to play. Hi again, everybody. Welcome to DeKalb. Alongside my partners, Buckeye Robert Smith and Bruin David Norrie, I'm Clay Matvick. We're glad to have you along here tonight. We should have a good game. Toledo got devastating news last week. They lost their starting quarterback, Austin Danton. And for most teams, that would be a gut punch. But Toledo likes the guy that's next in line.
Yeah, they really do. And it's Terrence Owen, a very young redshirt freshman quarterback that stepped in there. And he has really done extremely well. 10 of 15 last week against Eastern Michigan. And when you watch this guy on film, he does a very good job of moving around in the pocket. He also runs the ball extremely well. And most importantly, I think, he takes care of the football. 5 touchdowns, no interceptions on the year. And that's going to be very important coming on the road against a Northern Illinois defense that's second in the league in interceptions, only behind his Toledo team with 14 interceptions on the year.
Now, incidentally, Northern Illinois should have lost its starting quarterback months ago, David, but Chandler Harnish has defied the odds, and he's turned out to be the best quarterback in the MAC this year.
Well, he's come back from a devastating knee injury in this very game a year ago, and defenses love to load up the box against Chad Spann, their tailback, a guy who's already gone over 1,000 yards. The problem is Chandler Harnish is so dangerous passing the football. He's the number one rated passer in the MAC. He's averaging 66% on his completion rate. And as a runner, he might even be more dangerous. And there's no ball carrier that averages a higher yards per carry than Chandler Harnish, 5.9 yards per carry. So you load up the box against Spann, you pick your poison, and Chandler Harnish really is the reason that Northern Illinois is in this position right now.
It should be fun, and a lot of focus on two quarterbacks here tonight. Everybody in attendance in black tonight in DeKalb. A blackout for Toledo and Northern Illinois. First place on the line in the MAC West. Kickoff coming up next.
How about the taste of a barbie on the beach this holiday? Come on into Outback and try our special sirloin served with our freshly grilled lobster tails. It's here for a limited time at just $14.95. And purchase $100 in gift cards, get a $20 bonus card free. It's always fresh in the Outback.
Lose the grime. Get touch of your clean hair with Axe shampoo. Get some hair action.
On November 19th, the finale of the worldwide phenomenon begins.
We can end this.
Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows, Part 1, rated PG-13, starts November 19th.
AT&T introduces a new Windows phone with beauty and brains. A phone that gets you to the stuff you love faster, only from AT&T. Rethink possible.
Husky fans have the Thunder Sticks ready to go here in DeKalb tonight for Toledo and Northern Illinois. And there's Jerry Kill in his third year as head coach of the Huskies, poised to become the first Northern Illinois head coach to lead a team to 3 straight bowls. His counterpart is Tim Beckman. In his second season as head coach of the Rockets, 45 years old, worked with Urban Meyer at Bowling Green, Jim Tressel at Ohio State, and now finally getting his chance, and he's doing some great things at Toledo. Toledo has won the toss. They have deferred. Northern Illinois will receive. And this is the best start in conference play since 2004 for the Huskies. They started 6-0 that year in the MAC. And coincidentally enough, that season, their first loss at home that year was to Toledo. And the Rockets coming in here trying to knock him off again.
Yeah, you know, this is really a young Toledo team as well. Had the opportunity to call a game with them last year against Central Michigan. And Coach Beckman has done a great job of developing these young players. 18 out of 44 on the 2 deep are still just freshmen or sophomore.
And side. We're underway. Andrew Elker kicks it off. Tommy Davis on the return. And he is tripped up at the 22, falls ahead, and is down at the 27-yard line. A 23-yard return, and Northern Illinois ready to go to work here on offense. We're going to take our first look at Chandler Harnish, third-year starter. And this guy, we've touched on him already, he is just having a big year.
Yeah, a lot of people thought he was going to have to retire from the game last January. He went and saw a specialist, had the ACL. The specialist said he probably can't play again. A tremendous effort in terms of rehabbing during the offseason, and the combination of his accuracy as a passer and his ability on the zone read to keep the football and attack defenses with his feet. He's a special quarterback.
And he's going to start out under center. He'll send his fullback Kyle Scarve in motion. First play is on the ground, and that's what Northern Illinois likes to do. It's Chad Spann, and little or no gain for Northern Illinois. And here's a look at the lineups tonight. Northern Illinois number one in the MAC in rushing, 243 yards per game. Spann four straight 100-yard games, and that offensive line sure deserves a lot of credit for this run game. Amazingly, Jackson, Wettage, and Otis are first-year starters. Second down and eight after the two-yard gain by Spann. Harnish out of the gun. Has time, throws over the middle. It's complete to Martell Moore. It's going to be a couple of yards short of the first down. Here's that Toledo defense. It's third in the MAC against the run, and they're going to need to be on their game tonight. TJ Fatinikin is the team's sack leader. He comes off the edge. Strong side linebacker Isaiah Ballard. He'll be critical in the run game and the pass defense. And Desmond Merrill having a solid senior year at corner with three interceptions.
Desmond Merrill is another guy that's an incredible story coming back from injury. They're trying to get him a sixth year. He's missed a couple years because of some bad injuries.
Trying to convert on third down. Harnish is going to step up. He is good on his feet. Gets to the 40. First down and 10, Northern Illinois.
I tell you, that's the amazing thing about Harnish. I mean, he's not just a drop back quarterback. You know, not any drop back quarterback could come back from injury, but to be able to come back and do the things that he can do, you know, you hit it on it earlier, David, to be able to run the zone read, and what he did right there, so dangerous.
Yeah, and a nice, you know, decisive move to pull the ball down and move the chains.
On first down, they go back to the ground here. And it's going to be a three-yard pickup for Spann. Talked about his four straight 100-yard games, 1,000 yards on the year. 111 yards per game. That leads the MAC. He's going to be fun to watch tonight.
Yeah, he's a throwback player. Yeah, he's what we like to call a downhill runner, and he finds a little softness, a little crease, and he hits it, and he is a very good back finishing runs. Very physical.
Second down and seven for Northern Illinois on their first possession of the night. And again, it's Spann. Left side this time. And a one-yard pickup. And you talked about it, David. They're going to load the box tonight. Toledo is against this Northern Illinois offense.
If there's one thing a defensive coordinator doesn't want to see is a team control the ball all night on the ground, Robert.
Yeah, there's no question. And talking to defensive coordinator Mike Ward, he said what they wanted to try and do is bubble the A-gaps. And what that means is you get penetration in the A-gaps, and you force Chad Spann to not get downhill, to make him bounce things to get outside. Of course, that really puts a premium on tackling from your corner position, which will be an interesting thing for us to watch as the night goes on.
Spann cuts it up, first down and more. Ball comes loose, but he was already down. It's a 12-yard pickup for Spann. Second third down conversion for Northern Illinois in this series.
Well, Spann proved that he can bounce it right there.
Yeah, he really did. And once again, we just talked about this. The cornerbacks have got to be better in recognizing run and coming up and making plays. That time, Tyquan Page, number two, just did not get in fast enough. You have to see that Spann is trying to bounce the ball, come up and make a play.
Reddish steps up. He throws. It's complete to the 40-yard line. And it's Martell Moore. That's his second catch here tonight. A 4-yard pickup. Brings up second down and 6 for the Huskies. This offense, guys, it is fun to watch. Number one in rushing. Number one in scoring. Pass efficiency. Total offense in the MAC. It's a very balanced offense.
They take care of the ball as well. You know, Harnish only 4 interceptions on the season, and they've only turned it over 11 times. We're already into November.
Second down and 6, Northern Illinois on the move. Handoff. No, good fake by Harnish, and he dives ahead. He's going to be just shy of the first down, a 5-yard pickup for the quarterback who can run as well as throw.
And just your basic zone read here, reading that defensive end. Defensive end crashes. Dan Moles tries to make the play, but Harnish is already upfield. He is very good at recognizing here and getting vertical immediately. Doesn't dance around. Very physical for a quarterback. Of course, that can be dangerous at times, as we've seen with guys like Denard Robinson.
First down, Northern Illinois. Chad Spann, third down conversion on this drive. They come into the game 52% on the year. That again, first in the MAC, ninth in the nation.
And again, they go to the zone read. This time, Harnish makes a nice read, leaves the ball with Spann. And when you've got a guy that's as seasoned as Harnish is on that decision, it is very tough for a defense to play both quarterback and tailback.
Tenth play of the drive. On first down, Spann. Got a little running room on the far sideline and stopped at the 22-yard line by Archie Donald, who leads Toledo in tackles again. Could be the first player in team history to do that.
I really like the way that they have this play designed. They get Kyle Scarb. They use their H-back, fullback combinations in a lot of different ways, and they motion them to get them in position to cut off backsides. Makes it easy sometimes. I shouldn't say easy, but it makes it easier for a running back like Chad Spann to find space on that offensive line when you've got somebody cutting off.
Kreider comes in and Spann takes a rest. Third pass play of this series and is complete for a first down. First catch tonight for Willie Clark, coming off a career-high 7 catches for 70 yards and a touchdown in that win over Western Michigan. He gets 8 here and another Northern Illinois first down.
Yeah, Clark's a guy who can get off the line of scrimmage very well. He excels against press coverage, and you get a look at the footwork of Harnish in the pocket. He's back 3 or 5 steps. The ball comes out quickly, and very tough to defense that route when the ball comes out with that kind of timing.
First down and 10 at the Toledo 14. Deep handoff. Wow. Inside the 5, there is Ricky Kreider, the veteran back, who is a great compliment to the guy they call C-SPAN. And Kreider's fun to watch, too.
Boy, nice physical run here, too, by Kreider. Finds a crease. You can see Scarb again being a lead blocker. Kreider just busted on up in there. Running people over, not very big, but he's powerful and deliberate.
Stop short of the goal line.
Heard some oohs and ahs in the stadium on that. When you hear those pads popping, gets people excited up in the stands.
That looked like Archie Donald meeting the ball carrier in midair, and he won that battle.
Donald, the senior out of Pittsburgh. Singer also in on the tackle. Mark Singer, the free safety. Last couple of weeks, he has really elevated his game for Toledo. So now second down and goal for Northern Illinois. An impressive opening drive. Spann. Touchdown, Huskies. Chad Spann, 8 carries, 32 yards, and that touchdown on the drive, his 13th of the year. Impressive. impressive sight a couple of days before Veterans Day. Early lead for Northern Illinois as Michael Klubmoski comes in for the extra point. Salvo by Northern Illinois. 14-play drive and a touchdown for Jerry Kill's squad, but there might be a penalty flag down here on the extra point. Referee tonight is Mike Conlon.
After the play, personal foul. Face mask, defense, number 52. The 15-yard penalty will be assessed on the kickoff.
So everything going the Huskies' way here early on. Senior night here at home for Northern Illinois. 21 seniors playing their final home game tonight, including Chad Spann, who takes it in from a couple of yards out.
Kowalczyk.
Emergency, Kowalczyk.
What is your emergency?
The intern forgot the donuts for the status meeting.
Bingo.
It's okay. I'm on a mission.
Professional driver, closed course.
That's right. We put a turbo in a sport cross. The all-new Nissan Juke. Innovation for success. Innovation for all.
Many will hear the calling.
Move it!
Yes, sir!
Few will earn the title United States Marine. The few, the proud Marines.
The Premier Rewards Gold Card from American Express is designed to be brilliant. It's the only charge card to earn triple points on airfare, double points on gas and groceries, a single point on everything else. Points you can use for over a million rewards, including travel on any airline, anytime. The annual fee for the first year is on us, and you can earn 10,000 bonus points with your first purchase. Start earning brilliantly. Call 1-800-AXP-GOLD or visit axpgold.com to apply.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
Absolutely glorious night in DeKalb, Illinois. 55 degrees at game time, light winds. Alongside Robert Smith and David Norrie, I'm Clay Matvick. Northern Illinois with an impressive 14-play drive to start this game, jumping out on top. And one statistic, one stat that Northern Illinois is leading in the MAC that we forgot to mention, also time of possession, 7:20 off the clock in that opening drive.
When you have 1,000 yards, as Spann does, this is a classic running team, but they have the ability to hurt you in so many ways when you load up against them.
Klubmoski kicks it deep, and this is going to sail through the end zone and hit the goalpost. Boy, that's what a coach likes to see after a touchdown.
We're going to take a look at this play here and watch big number 72, Joe Pavlock, pull around here, and you're going to see Archie Donald comes and just, he takes this on the wrong way in the hole. Got to really just take this right down the middle. Pavlock, some pretty good feet for a guy, 301 pounds. But as you see right there, Donald just turned his body. You can't do that down on the goal line. You can just have, if you see somebody pulling there, you got to blow him up and make that running back reroute.
Yeah, 6'5", 301 pounds, Pollock. All he has to do is just get a jersey on a jersey there, and that's enough for a back with the talent of a Chad Spann.
So the penalty on the extra point, helping get the kick off the goalpost. They spot it at the 20 now. Toledo's first possession out of the gun. Terrence Owens, spin move here by Adonis. Thomas, nowhere to go. Thomas dropped in the backfield, a loss of four. As we get our first look at Terrence Owens, the quarterback, a redshirt freshman out of Cleveland, making his first career start tonight. The starter, Austin Danton, out with a shoulder injury. They hope he could return if Toledo gets to bowl game.
Well, we know that Terrence Owens is a quality guy because he had a quality high school coach there with Ted Ginn at Glenville High School in Cleveland. Produces so many great players and really teaches them to be good people.
Thomas again, he gets some of that yardage back. Not much. Here's Butler, Devon Butler, the team's leader in sacks, second on the team in tackles. Well, Thomas is the leading rusher. He's going to touch it about 20, 25 times. Eric Page, eighth nationally at seven catches per game. All upperclassmen up front. Vanderbilt making his 34th consecutive start tonight. A third and long situation right out of the gate here for Toledo. Has time. The southpaw escapes the tackle. Now runs. Three and out for the Rockets.
When we talked to the offensive coordinator, Matt Campbell, for Toledo earlier this week, he said this Northern Illinois defense is going to be the biggest test of the year. They got talent at all three levels, very experienced in the secondary, and, you know, Owens is going to have his best game of the season tonight. He's going to be the key. He has to be error-free, and he has to make a lot of plays for this Toledo offense.
Vince Penzer, the Mac West Special Teams Player of the Week, comes on to kick for Toledo. Tommy Davis is back, fields it at the 32. Sidesteps one tackler, gets across the 40-yard line down at the 42. And Northern Illinois up by a touchdown. They scored on their opening drive. We'll get it back when we come back.
Keep it up, right?
Now, more than ever, you want to keep your loved ones safe and secure. Give them the gift of financial security from New York Life. We've been protecting families for over 165 years. New York Life, the company you keep.
You are largely nocturnal. You tend to run in a pack. And while quick to share with others, there is only one of you. The Droid Incredible by HTC. You are a social animal. You need the droid that is too. Exclusively at Verizon.
Jack Link's Beef Jerky presents Messin' with Sasquatch.
Hey, look. Check this out. Hey, buddy, try this. Mmm, it's real good. You can do it. Come on. Yeah, try the poke. Come on. Yeah, try. Yum, yum, yum.
Jack Link's Jerky. Feed your wild side.
With Orbitz, I know what to expect from my vacation. Bad dog balloon pop. Because Orbitz has price assurance. Leaf and face, marine, man with computer. If another Orbitz customer books the same hotel or flight for less, they'll send me a check for the difference automatically. So I know I'll get their lowest price. And I like knowing what to expect. Bike, unrealistic splash, embarrassingly transparent.
When you Orbitz, you know.
Taco Bell's new Double XL Chalupa. Double the beef, loads of nacho cheese sauce, and tons of toppings in a monster chalupa shell. It's so big, you better call in a closer.
Don't worry, kid. I got it.
Go get him, Mo.
Nope. Think outside the bun.
You have dreams for your children. Don't let times like these stand in the way of them. Protect your family with the gift of financial security, backed by the highest possible ratings for financial strength. New York Life, the company you keep.
ESPN's College Football Primetime, brought to you by Nissan, proud partner of the Heisman Trophy.
Back here at DeKalb, 7-0 Northern Illinois. 14-play opening drive for the Huskies. Toledo going 3-and-out on their first series. And now Northern Illinois has it at their own 41. 5:36 to go, opening quarter. Winner of this game takes over first place in the MAC West. Chandler Harnish hands off. Here's Chad Spann. Another good run on first down. Archie Donald, another tackle, gets Spann 7.
Now for a north-south runner, he sure gets outside in a hurry. I mean, he is quick getting to the perimeter.
Yeah, he's got great flexible hips. He can bounce outside and, you know, really puts a lot of pressure on defenses. It looks like some guys are out of place, though. You know, you have to be really sound with your technique. And if it's your job to turn the play back in, that's what you have to do. And if it's your job to scrape up over the top, you have to get in position.
Harnish pump fake, rolling to his right. Has a man open at the 40. Got by the tight end, Jack Marks. Pickup of 12 and a Northern Illinois first down. And Robert, here's another look at the play as Mike Ward's got to be scratching his head.
Yeah, he really does. And, you know, a 7-minute drive, then you have a 3-and-out. Now your defense has to go right back on the field. Nice job, Chandler Harnish, kind of misdirecting the defense there a little bit, allowing Jack Mark some time to get back and find an opening.
Mike Ward, the defensive coordinator for Toledo. On first down, play fake. Harnish has time, wants to go deep. To the end zone, man open, overshot the intended receiver, Willie Clark.
Well, they told us Willie Clark's not the fastest guy on the team. Very good off the line, but it looked like he had enough speed there to get behind everybody. You can see, tried to chase him down there. Desmond Morrow there on the coverage. Boy, he almost had that one.
And Harnish showed me some arm strength right there. Put that ball up effortlessly and with some touch on it. You can tell that Harnish, there's a reason why he leads the conference in passing efficiency.
And Jordan Lynch, the backup quarterback, comes in. He has a package of plays to showcase his running ability, and he will do just that. You can see why they bring him in. He is a nice change of pace, guys.
Yeah, he really is. I mean, obviously, Chandler Harnish can run the football as well, but Jordan Lynch, even quicker, it looks like, really gets into the hole very fast.
And you load up the box, as we say, against Chad Spann, and what makes this offense so special is you have Harnish's ability to pass the ball and run the football, and then you bring Jordan in, and they can attack you so many different ways outside of just Chad Spann punishing you between the tackles.
Northern Illinois 3-for-3 on third down conversions tonight already. They've already gone over 100 yards total offense. This time Chad Spann is going to be dumped for a loss. And now a decision here for Jerry Kill.
Well, this section of the field, it's, I think, a good decision. You know, you don't pick up a lot by punting. You either take a shot at a 50-plus yard field goal or you go for it. And I like going for it here because, you know, the odds are pretty good. This is a manageable fourth down and short.
Looks like Jordan Lynch is back in the game. And I'll tell you, the good thing about having a second quarterback like that, with this type of offense, you can split those carries up for the running backs. We talked earlier about Denard Robinson being hurt. Joshua Nesbitt got hurt down there at Georgia Tech. It's tough on those running quarterbacks.
Lynch at the controls on 4th and 3. He'll take it. And he stopped. Ball comes loose at the end. They're going to rule him down. Lynch tried to reach for the first down. Ball popped loose. Marked down. Desmond Merrill there on the stop. So Jerry Kill goes for it. Toledo comes up defensively.
Romero is a big cornerback at 6'2", and that's a nice open field tackle. Singer, the safety, coming out to the perimeter to clean up.
Northern Illinois leading by a touchdown late in the first.
With deposits in your engine, it can feel like something's holding your car back.
Let me guess, 16.
That's why there's Castrol GTX. With our most powerful deposit-fighting ingredient ever, Castrol GTX exceeds the toughest new industry standard. Don't let deposits hold your car back. Get Castrol GTX. It's more than just oil. It's liquid engineering.
ESPN is a brand new channel.
goal line.
Rod and I are going to be your remote control. You can keep it here. We're going to flip through the most compelling action every Saturday.
Come tomorrow, there will be a new number one.
This is Nirvana.
Goal Line takes you around the country to see all the big moments and the drive to the national championship live.
He'll take it to the house.
For when it counts on Saturday, watch ESPN Goal Line. Saturdays noon to midnight. Available on Time Warner Cable, Verizon Fios, and Bright House Networks.
The road to success is never easy, and no one gets there on talent alone. Introducing the K-Factor, a patented system designed to help pitchers take their game to a whole new level. By combining a resistance system with basic pitching drills, the K-Factor focuses on the importance of proper mechanics. Pitchers at all levels will learn to increase arm speed, maximize the length of the arm circle, and strengthen the wrist for better snap. Use the K-Factor as part of your daily workout or during your pregame warm-up. You'll develop healthy muscle memory, build strength and endurance, add overall velocity to pitches, and achieve consistency on the mound. There has never been a tool more valuable for your performance. Order the K-Factor now and start reaching your maximum potential.
ESPN's College Hoops Tip-Off Marathon is back. That means 24 consecutive hours of live college basketball, 21 games featuring four of the top five men's teams, and you get your first look at both defending national champs, the Duke men and the UConn women. The tips off following Monday Night Football on ESPN. It's that time of year, and Duke number one again this year in men's college hoops. 7-0, Northern Illinois leading as Toledo defensively get a nice stop. Take over on downs here at the 31. Owens complete. First down, Toledo. Eric Page with his first catch tonight. He is a good one. A gain of 12. And then Northern Illinois defense. We talked about Jake Kaufman, 26-year-old senior at defensive end, two tours in Iraq. We're going to be telling his story tonight. Middle linebacker Devon Butler, he is the team sack leader. Three seniors in the secondary and a sophomore, free safety Tommy Davis. Inside handoff. It's going to be a short pickup for Morgan Williams, who splits time with Adonis Thomas. And it really depends on who's hot and who gets more carries.
Well, and Adonis Thomas has definitely been the back with the hot hand as of late. A traditional type of scat back. Great speed. He sets things up with one cut, and they work both backs into the lineup together at times.
Second and eight, play fake. Owens deep down the middle of the field and incomplete. Intended for Page again. He is Toledo's leading receiver. Pretty good coverage there by Tommy Davis.
Yeah, and Eric Page, almost four times more receptions than any other receiver on this team. And you can see that speed that that young guy has right there. Used him a little bit as a wildcat quarterback last season. He was a quarterback in high school. He's a lot of fun to watch. Just a sophomore. He's going to be doing a lot of damage for a while in the MAC.
Runs a high school at Springfield High School in Toledo, just 10 minutes from campus. Here's a third down and eight. Hit as he throws. Almost complete. Morgan Williams almost got that ball that was tipped by Butler.
Well, you know what? I think it's interesting to note Terrence Owens, last week playing against Eastern Michigan, had all kinds of time to throw the football. Against this Northern Illinois defense, things are a little bit different, and you have got to have that internal clock as a quarterback. Am I right, David? I mean, you just have to know that the pressure is about to get there.
Yeah, you have to have your eyes trained down the field, but you have to feel the pass rush, and that time Owens very lucky to get the ball back.
Second punt tonight for Vince Penza. And off the side of his foot, out of bounds at about the 22-yard line. And they are going to spot it, actually, at the 26. With a minute and a half to go here in the first quarter, a 30-yard punt for Penza. Let's get a SportsCenter right now with Ryan Burr in Bristol.
Thanks so much. The University of Colorado announced this morning that Dan Hawkins has been relieved of his duties as the head coach of the Buffaloes, effective immediately. Longtime assistant coach Brian Cabral will serve as an interim head coach. FoxSports.com reporting that Auburn quarterback Cam Newton was facing possible expulsion from the University of Florida for academic cheating when he transferred to a junior college. His head coach Gene Chizik calls the allegations garbage. SportsCenter on ESPN News. Guys.
Thank you very much. Back here in DeKalb. First down for Northern Illinois, and Harnish goes about to Landon Cox.
Yeah, that was uncharacteristic of Chandler Harnish right there. He had a receiver settling down in a little void wide open, and that was a misfire to the outside. He actually let the ball out towards the defensive back, very close to an interception.
Chad Spann out of the backfield to the Huskies. And he'll get a penalty flag down.
Looked like Toledo was in the neutral zone.
Spann on the carry, tackled in by three, Justin Merrill. Flag on the play.
Offsides, defense, number 94. 5-yard penalty, repeat, second down.
Northern Illinois has taken the fewest penalties in the MAC this year. Toledo has taken the most.
And that's going to kill you. You just can't afford to do things like that, especially against an offense like Northern Illinois that's just so efficient. And you saw that methodical drive to start the game. Just especially guys over the ball, it always drives you crazy. You have to just watch the ball. Don't listen to the cadence.
Trouble with the exchange. Spann takes it right out of Barnish's hands and gets it up for the first down. College football primetime continuing on ESPN and ESPN2 Thursday night at 7 Eastern on ESPN. The Pittsburgh Panthers eyeing the Big East BCS bid with a win over Connecticut. Then on ESPN2 Friday at 9 Eastern, Kellen Moore leads fourth-ranked Boise against Idaho. College football on ESPN Thursday and ESPN2 Friday. Is there any way that Boise can jump TCU?
No, I think it's going to be difficult.
On first down. Under a half minute to go here is Ricky Kreider. Gets up after the carry.
And Robert Smith has TCU up in his number one spot, which surprised me, opened my eyes a little bit. And
the only one of those top teams that actually plays defense. I think that's important when you're talking about championship level teams. I know everybody talks about the competition that people are facing, but I like that TCU being a complete team.
Yeah, no doubt they play the best defense of the top three or four teams, but I think there's a couple teams that play better offense than TCU in that
Northern
top four.
Illinois dominating the time of possession in that first quarter, 11 minutes 27 seconds, and they lead it 7-0.
Join Boomer and the gang for Sunday NFL Countdown, 11 a.m. on ESPN.
It's positive.
Positive.
We're gonna have a baby.
Now, when I was a little boy, age of five.
The four-door sports car. Nissan Maxima. Innovation for daddy. Innovation for all.
Get a new Maxima for 1.9% APR plus 500 cash back.
$15.99 doesn't get you much at other restaurants. But at Dave & Buster's, $15.99 gets you the Eat & Play combo. Get a $10 game card and your choice of 8 delicious entrees. Why just eat when you can eat and play at Dave & Buster's?
Beat your worst flu symptoms. New Theraflu Max D contains the most powerful medicine allowable without a prescription to fight your worst flu symptoms. Theraflu Max D. Serious power.
State Farm agent Carrie Maddox
loves to tell everyone how drivers can get discounts up to 40%.
Your neighbors
can tell you, too. They're probably some of State Farm's 40 million drivers, so talk to them. Then call a State Farm agent like me.
Call her.
Is it the end of TV as you know it? It's
the LG Infinia, the world's first full LED 3D TV, and the only LED TV that's THX certified for picture quality. So, is it a TV or something better?
What happened to tequila? These days, it's all velvet ropes and posturing. I don't know about you, but when I drink it, I really like to kick back and be myself. Oops.
1800 Tequila. Change the game.
We talk about traditions. We talk about
the big turkey and the big pernil.
I call Europe a lot. Italy, Spain.
I'm in touch with old friends.
My mom and I are very chatty.
That's one of the cool things with Vonage. It's one set price, unlimited calling, and that no surprises at the end of the month.
No annual contract? I mean, that's even better.
Once you try it, you're going to stick with it.
I'm Judy Compress, and this was my last bill before I switched to Vonage.
This holiday, switch your home phone to Vonage and get unlimited domestic and international calling now with no annual contract.
ESPN College Football. College football lives here.
Honey, is that you?
And here. And it probably shouldn't live here, but it does. And awkwardly enough, here too.
Do you mind?
And yep. Even here. ESPN College Football, live on TV, online, on your phone, and in 3D.
Here's a look at Garrett Wolf, former Northern Illinois great, now member of the Chicago Bears, honored as a Husky legend here tonight between quarters. 57 total touchdowns. That's an NIU record.
11 out of the last 12 seasons, Northern Illinois has had a back over 1,000 yards. Garrett Wolf, the last running back here to go over 1,000 yards in back-to-back seasons, and Chad Spann has done it.
Want to throw? No. Harnish wants to roll out, still looking downfield. And he got it complete on the sideline to Perez Ashford. His first catch, it's a pickup of 5. And just when you think Harnish is going to do one thing, he does another. He's got the ability to do both.
Well, he's so effective from the pocket, but the coaches say he's even more comfortable when he's on the move.
Yeah, that's what he says. He likes to get on the move. And as you said earlier, you know, those some of those quarterbacks, the young quarterbacks or shorter quarterbacks, it's not necessarily that they want to just take off and run, but they like to get open passing lanes. It's a lot easier to see what's going on with the defense once they get away from that jumbled mess.
Quick throw to the flat. And it's a first down for Landon Cox. Cox, the big veteran receiver, picks up 5 at a Northern Illinois first down.
Now, this is one of the new ideas over the last 4 or 5 years in college football. Run plays called at the line of scrimmage from time to time. A quarterback has the freedom to look outside and audible quickly. Sometimes without audibling, he'll just stand up and get the ball outside even though a run play has been called.
Nice block there by Willie Clark. Drove Tyquan Page all the way out of bounds. Way to finish out there.
Harnish wants to throw again. Incomplete. Nathan Palmer tried to haul it in with his right hand. The big playmaker comes up empty. Second down at 10. Harnish now 5 of 8 passing, 35 yards. Your impressions of this guy here tonight so far, Dave?
Well, I think it's just an amazing story that he's even out on the field. I mean, to have as devastating a knee injury as he had and then to come back without having surgery after an ACL. They didn't start him in the first game, and here he is leading the conference in passing, and he has the biggest average per carry of any running back or quarterback in the league.
Yeah, 4-year starter in high school in basketball in Indiana, so you know he's a pretty good player there, too.
Steps out of a tackle and been met by Archie Donald. Donald has been busy tonight. It's a pickup of 2 for Harnish. And guys, Harnish 10 days ago at Western Michigan led the Huskies on a game-winning touchdown drive with under 5 minutes to play. So not only is this guy physically tough, but he is emotionally, mentally tough as well.
Yeah, he really is. And I think any player that's really had to deal with the adversity of severe injury, you come back and you're just a changed man, really, because anything that can be thrown at you, you know you've been through that physical pain, and the physical pain isn't isn't really as bad to you. In the back of your mind, it's not as difficult because you've already experienced it.
Play fake on third down and eight. Harnish, feeling the heat, throws it downfield. It's complete to Martell Moore. Slips away from a tackler, picks up the first down and more. Down inside the 30-yard line, it's a 20-yard gain.
This is a special play by Harnish. You talk about extending a play and helping your offensive line. And he's going to face pressure in the pocket. The fake, and then he's going to have to retreat to his right. Watch him get the ball outside with some velocity on it. Places it perfectly to the outside with two defenders draped on him in the pocket. That is a great play by a quarterback.
Tyquan Page should have made the tackle. As it stands, Northern Illinois with a first and 10. Handoff. Span. Pick up a couple. And this team for Northern Illinois, great at home. 5-1 last year, 4-0 this year, 13-3 under Jerry Kill. That's one thing that has happened since he got the job here a few years ago. They really protect their home field well, and tonight they've made a statement here early.
They really have, and I'll tell you, this is just a great environment for people that haven't been out to some of the MAC games. You really get some nice crowds the very end of these games. Obviously, this is a big one for supremacy in the West in the MAC. This is a great place to see a game.
10th play of the drive to the end zone. Contact, flags down. Willie Clark may have been interfered with. We'll have to see. Byron Best, the field corner, in on the coverage.
Yeah, Best was really squeezing him down the sideline. And he really ran Clark right out of bounds with that right elbow.
I know that's you're one way to get it done.
I know you're trying to take the territory on that fade route, but
first down.
When the ball's in the air, you can't interrupt the route with that much contact. Tim Beckman looking for an
uncatchable
ball.
Third penalty tonight against Toledo. And that Toledo secondary tied for first in the nation with 16 interceptions. There's some insight into how they're getting it done.
That's a little way to do it, isn't it?
Cutting some corners.
Well, you bend the rules slightly.
If you ain't cheating, you ain't trying.
Who was it that said that anyway?
Somebody in the NASCAR circuit, I think.
Jordan Lynch checks back in at quarterback. Hands off. Touchdown, Northern Illinois. Akeem Daniels takes it in on the jet sweep. And the Huskies, very impressive again. Another long drive.
Daniels is their jet sweep motion specialist. They have four pretty talented wide receivers. All are capable of leading you in receptions from week to week. And then they bring in Daniels, and he's the jet sweep guy. Always a threat to run the football.
You can see why they use him on the jet sweep. He doesn't play around. He's also a very deliberate runner like Chad Spann. Not a lot of dance in there. Very fast. Just get the ball and get downfield.
First a 14-play touchdown drive, now a 10-play touchdown drive for Northern Illinois. Akeem Daniels on senior night, the rookie, making a contribution. All Huskies here early in the second.
The next big thing from Lexus is not a car. It's the idea that a car that will never have an accident may be possible. In pursuit of this goal, Lexus developed the world's most advanced driving simulator, where a real driver in a real car can react to real situations without real consequences. The breakthroughs we innovate here may someday make all cars safer. This is the pursuit of tomorrow. This is the pursuit of perfection.
It's like a blast of hydration. The new Schick Hydro. Water-activated gel hydrates your skin as you shave, and skin guards reduce irritation. It's the best shave for your skin. Schick Hydro. Free your skin.
crave Doritos Late Night Cheeseburger.
Hi, I'm Ray Lewis. Women want me, men want to be me, and animals want to learn how to talk so they can hang out with me. Do you want to know why?
Why?
Old Spice Showtime deodorant.
That makes sense.
It's time for the Bud Light Playbook. Today, spelling counts, even in football.
We're on the double trunk. Look! Oh!
Oh, my goodness. This don't look right, fellas.
Oh, guys.
Watch out, left, left.
Saw you on the big screen.
Mm-hmm. There we go.
Thank you.
Here we go.
Never send the Z's for Bud Light.
Bud Light, the sure sign of a good time.
Here we go.
Northern Illinois freshman Akeem Daniels, the rookie from Kissimmee, Florida. Northern Illinois leads it 14-0. College football primetime continuing on ESPN and ESPN2. Thursday night at 7:30 Eastern on ESPN. The Pitt Panthers taking on UConn. Then on ESPN2, Friday at 9 Eastern, Kellen Moore leading 4th-ranked Boise against Idaho. In-state battle, of course, the Broncos, the heavy favorites in that one. Any chance, guys, any chance that you get into that national title picture?
For Boise State? I don't think so. You know, in the human polls, TCU jumped ahead of Boise State for the first time last week. And I think the impressive win that TCU had over Utah last week, a team that was definitely overrated, but an impressive win there, impressive win over Oregon State and Baylor earlier in the year, I think is going to keep them ahead if they win out, which they should. They've got New Mexico and San Diego State left.
Well, I just think that is one of the big weaknesses with the system we have in place right now. To put TCU into that game ahead of Boise State after Boise State has taken care of all the business that has been presented to them this year, that is one of my biggest arguments, that you have to have a playoff, because for one of those two teams, if they both go undefeated, to be left out of the national title game, I think it's a crime. Just the 8th play tonight for Toledo. Terrence Owens flares it up. Incomplete.
Well, I would say, though, if Oregon and Auburn both run the table, and I think Oregon is going to run the table. I think Oregon's going to be in the national title game. Auburn, a much, much tougher road. But if Oregon and Auburn run the table, then I don't think TCU or Boise State belongs in that game. Now, you might disagree with me on that, Robert. I know you have TCU in your number one slot right now. Yeah, but, you know, I think TCU is the best team in the country. But it's hard for me to justify it. Really is. It's hard for me to justify if those other teams go undefeated to keep them out of the title game. And I think that is one of the weaknesses of this system. And that's why I'd like to see a plus one model.
They pick up the first down at 2nd and 10. Eric Page gets the 10 yards necessary. First down for Toledo.
You know, you watch Oregon right now. Chip Kelly, I think he may be as good as there is in the business. The way that he is operating that offensive attack, unbelievable.
Thomas and Williams in the backfield to either side of Terrence Owens. Big drive here for Toledo. Owens to the flat, caught by Thomas. First down. Tiptoes along the sideline. Big play for Adonis Thomas. Offensive coordinator Matt Campbell expected him to get tonight between 15 and 25 touches, rushing and receiving. He can do both very well.
Well, this was a huge drive for Toledo. Down 14-0. Terrence Owens, a little flip pass out there to Adonis Thomas. And this is getting them right back in the ball game. This is what you have to do. You're on the road. You drop down 14-0. You cannot have a 3-and-out.
And now they may go upstairs.
The previous play is under further review.
Replay official tonight is John Corris.
And more than anything, you need to string together some first downs and give your defensive team a chance to get on the bench for a while. And I think this review is going to give them a bit more time to catch their breaths. Northern Illinois controlling the football, and you see a couple taps there with the feet, touching the
the sideline, this Northern Illinois offense will wear you down.
Guys, just to throw another wrinkle into that conversation we were having, ESPN computer guru Brad Edwards thinks it's possible for Auburn, if they end up with one loss and that loss happens to be to Alabama, and still be ahead of TCU, according to the computers. What are your thoughts?
Well, you know how I feel about that. I think TCU is the best team in the country. I think they're the only one of those teams that plays great offensively and defensively. I thought that about Boise State until we had the chance to go out and see them play, actually. I think Lennon Creer, the running back from Louisiana Tech, really exposed that defense. TCU, nobody exposes that defense.
Yeah, you look at TCU, though, and you talk about Boise State being exposed on defense. They've played some great defense in some big games. So we saw what they did to Oregon in the opener last year. I know it's a different year, but you look at the games they've played, the bowl games they played against TCU the last 2 years, the Poinsettia and the Fiesta, and TCU has averaged
after
less than two
review,
touchdowns against
ruling
Boise
on the
State.
Field
so ruling on the field stands out of bounds at the 50-yard line. See the Toledo offense, first nine plays. 21 yards, picking it up a little bit, but they got a first down and 10. Again, Terrence Owens, the quarterback, making his first career start, comes over the middle, had that nearly picked off, almost intercepted. Danny Noble, the intended receiver, and Tommy Davis almost jumped in front of him.
Middle screens, you need to do that against a fast attacking defensive line like Northern Illinois has. I'm trying to sneak that thing in there, just couldn't get the pass through.
Pickup of six, so to bring up third down and manageable for Toledo. Terrence Owens, you guys, this has got to be a little nerve-wracking for the young man.
Well, I'll tell you what, you get an idea on that last play that he can execute in the pass game. That's real crisp footwork in the pocket. The ball's coming out on time and with accuracy.
What was your first road start?
BYU, opener my senior year, and they'd won 25 games in a row. Coming off a national championship in 84, BYU was.
Good luck. Owens complete, first down. Nice catch by Eric Page. He has got 43% of all of Toledo's receptions this year. That's 14 yards.
Yeah, he looks a lot like Patrick White. And a lot of people remember Patrick White's running ability and how explosive he was out of the open field, but he was close to a 70% passer at West Virginia.
Well, it looks like Owens starting to get comfortable in there. Obviously played a lot last week, 2 weeks ago against Eastern Michigan. Really settling down and moving this ball club the way that they need it to on this very important drive.
Page again. And another Rockets first down. That's a pickup of 10. And you were talking about Owens' game against Eastern Michigan. He completed just 10 passes in that game. All those yards because there's so many big plays. He had 234 yards and four touchdowns. He completed a 74, a 68, and a 53-yard touchdown pass in that game.
That was just like your first game at BYU, wasn't it?
Yeah, hardly.
They're doing it through the air on this drive. Lofts it toward the end zone, man wide open, incomplete. Tim Cortazzo couldn't haul it in.
You're going to come in against Northern Illinois and you're Toledo and you're trying to steal the driver's seat. In position to get into that MAC championship game, you have to take advantage of opportunities, and you cannot overthrow this ball out of the back of the end zone.
Got that adrenaline flowing, got a little bit excited there. Saw Cortazzo was wide open, and wanted to get the ball there in a hurry. But you're absolutely right, it's something that you can't afford to do.
red zone takeaways this season. This defense looking for a stop. A timeout called by Toledo. Well, this has been a pretty good drive for Tim Beckman's team. After the break, we'll see what they can do, if they can capitalize and get it in the end zone.
The next big thing from Lexus is not a car. It's the idea that a car that will never have an accident may be possible. In pursuit of this goal, Lexus developed the world's most advanced driving simulator, where a real driver in a real car can react to real situations without real consequences. The breakthroughs we innovate here may someday make all cars safer. This is the pursuit of tomorrow. This is the pursuit of perfection.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 57th President of the United States.
Fastest mobile broadband network, AT&T. Rethink possible. Introducing the HTC Surround, the new Windows phone, only from AT&T.
The road to success is never easy, and no one gets there on talent alone. Introducing the K-Factor, a patented system designed to help pitchers take their game to a whole new level. By combining a resistance system with basic pitching drills, the K-Factor focuses on the importance of proper mechanics. Pitchers at all levels will learn to increase arm speed, maximize the length of the arm circle, and strengthen the wrist for better snap. Use the K-Factor as part of your daily workout or during your pregame warm-up. You'll develop healthy muscle memory, build strength and endurance, add overall velocity to pitches, and achieve consistency on the mound. There has never been a tool more valuable for your performance. Order the K-Factor now and start reaching your maximum potential.
ESPN's College Football Primetime, brought to you by Lexus. This is the pursuit of tomorrow. This is the pursuit of perfection at AT&T.
Toledo needed to answer the bell, down 14-0. Their first two drives amounted to just 7 plays. This is already the 9th play coming up on a drive that started on the Rockets' own 20. Second down and 10. Play fake. Owens to the end zone. Man open, but overthrown. Incomplete, intended for Kenny Stafford.
You're not going to have any shot to hit these balls. And he had another opening here, but you're not going to have any shot to hit these balls unless you keep the ball in bounds.
Look out.
A lesser man would have been on his backside. Good job there, Stafford.
And a lot of military around to help him up. Crowd coming alive here on third down. They're 1-for-3 tonight on third down conversion attempts. Owens has time over the middle. Should have been caught. Incomplete. Eric Page, the intended receiver, fourth down.
I don't think he had much of a decision here. You got to take the points. You're down a couple touchdowns, and this is a manageable field goal attempt. It's like about a 38 or 39 yarder.
Bill Klaus coming on. A junior from Perrysburg, Ohio, 3-for-5 on the year. Has a long of 38. This is definitely within his range from 37. Out of the hold of Vince Penza. No good. Nice drive by the Rockets, but they come up empty.
Well, really demoralizing there. They've done such a good job of finally getting some first downs, giving the defense a little bit of a rest, get all the way down the field and miss the field goal. That's a kicker for you, right, David?
Well, and you talk about missed opportunities. You have a receiver wide open in the back of the end zone, no defender trailing him, and Terrence Owens was not able to keep the football in the field of play on the post route, and then you miss a short field goal, and you're still down 2 touchdowns.
That Toledo defense is going to start saying, hey, guys, come on, we need a little help. And they do. Chad Spann on first down. No running room right into the teeth of that Toledo front. It's going to be a loss of one. As Johnny Roberts, the nose, makes the tackle.
Well-rested defensive line now for Toledo. Able to make some plays, get in the backfield. Once again, this is what they had talked about coming into this ball game. Mike Ward, the defensive coordinator, saying they've really got to keep Chad Spann from getting that head of steam, getting downhill right away.
Harness keeps it himself on second down and 11. He's got the first down and much more. Penalty flag. Desmond Merrill escorted Harnish out of bounds, but he may have pulled a face mask.
Well, Harnish isn't the fastest.
Personal foul, face mask. Number three on the defense. 15-yard penalty, first down.
Harnish isn't the fastest or the quickest quarterback that we see running the ball out of the quarterback position, but he's very heady. And Willie Clark gets a nice block on the outside to create some additional yardage.
And that's the second time called Willie Clark for blocking, too. He's handling his business out there. Pretty clear right there. Just reaches around the front and grabs the bottom of that face mask.
Fourth penalty against Toledo, 50 yards against the Rockets and penalties tonight. Play action pass. Harnish has time, now steps up, wants to run another lane to do so. He is hit hard after a 7-yard pickup. Quickly on his feet, and that's a good sign. Archie Donald making the stop.
Harnish picks up a lot of yards by just being decisive when he pulls the football down.
Pretty good job here in the secondary for Toledo. Got everybody covered up. But yes, Chad Harnish just takes off. It's just so difficult to account for a quarterback like that that can run. You try your best to get a good pass rush on him, but if you don't get there in time and allow any type of space for him at all, he's going to take advantage of it.
Harnish again cuts it up, and he is going to be close to another Northern Illinois first down. Mike Ward, the defensive coordinator for Toledo, there you see him. He was adamant this week when we talked to him, guys. We've got to stop the run and take the ball away. So far tonight, they haven't been able to do either.
Yeah, and a lot of that has been the quarterbacks a lot of times not getting into position, bad scrapes, bad angles that people are taking, just little things. It's technique.
It really is the mantra of every defensive coordinator we hear week in and week out. We got to stop the run and we got to get some takeaways, but it's the way that they have to stop the run by loading up the box, getting an extra defender up near the line of scrimmage. And Northern Illinois is so well equipped to throw the ball. They're a team that can attack you with the quarterback off the zone read. And then they bring in Jordan as the Wildcat quarterback. And so you really can't load up against Northern Illinois without paying for it.
Northern Illinois averaging 243 yards on the ground per game. Well on their way to another big night, rushing 132 yards so far. Here's Spann on first down. He'll pick up one. The Huskies have outrushed their opponents in six straight and eight of the last nine. That's been the defensive coordinator's game plan, like you guys said, all season. How do we stop these guys on the ground?
Just got to win a lot of those individual matchups, quite frankly. This Northern Illinois offensive line has done such an excellent job. Really take on the defensive line in a solid way and create a lot of creases. Or just absolute push.
On second and nine, Harnish, man open, touchdown! Nathan Palmer, a 33-yard hookup with Harnish. He is their playmaker.
He's the slot, and he's the fastest wide receiver for Northern Illinois. And they set up a seam route against Morrow, and just a beautiful ball from Harnish over the top with touch, allowing Palmer to just run underneath the ball and cross the goal line.
Klimovsky comes on to tack on the extra point. And Northern Illinois with an impressive first half, and there's still 5:43 to go. Fourth touchdown of the year for Nathan Palmer. All Northern Illinois on senior night. And a big one in the MAC West.
The next big thing from Lexus is not a car. It's the idea that a car that will never have an accident may be possible. In pursuit of this goal, Lexus developed the world's most advanced driving simulator, where a real driver in a real car can react to real situations without real consequences. The breakthroughs we innovate here may someday make all cars safer. This is the pursuit of tomorrow. This is the pursuit of perfection.
Now by 7, final play for Detroit.
Only thing that would make this any better is overtime.
They'll need a miracle to win this football game. Aaron slot right, drops back. Hines takes the pass at the 30. With the seam! Wow, can you believe it? One man to beat! We're headed to overtime!
Buffalo Wild Wings, you have to be here.
Field goal for the win!
Go get him, Tiger.
When you're hitting the road for business,
good luck.
Enterprise will pick you up and get you on the road to success. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
The USO provides every American a way to support our wounded warriors and their families. Visit USO.org to learn how your donation can make a difference in their lives. The USO, until everyone comes home.
There's Nathan Palmer, number 81. He is the fastest of the Northern Illinois receivers, and he shows it here, gentlemen.
Yeah, let's take another look. A bunch set, and we're going to get a route here, and this is going to be Palmer, and he's going to come down the seam. And he's going to find himself man-to-man with Morrow and Harnish with touch over the top. It's a great play between quarterback and wide receiver.
Four drives now for Northern Illinois, three touchdowns. All of those touchdown drives, more than 10 plays. Tim Beckman. And these Toledo Rockets have been slapped around here in the first half. Time of possession is off the charts. Over 18 minutes for Northern Illinois. Page is going to bring it out. Probably wishes at this point he didn't. 17-yard return. Saturday afternoon on ABC and ESPN, Penn State looks to carry the momentum from Joe Paterno's 400th win against a ninth-ranked Ohio State team, inching closer to a possible Rose Bowl bid. Some of you will see Texas Tech, Oklahoma, or Virginia Tech, North Carolina college football presented by Kay Jewelers on ABC or ESPN at 3:30 Eastern. Congratulations to Joe Paterno.
Big 400th win. First big-time college football coach to do that. Is it John Gilardi up there?
John Gilardi, yeah. St. John's in Minnesota, yeah.
And Eddie Robinson, the other two that are in that 400 club. Rare air.
You got to coach a lot of football to get in that kind of position. Terrence Owens keeps it himself. It's a pickup of one for the Toledo quarterback. We talked earlier about Jake Kaufman as we're a couple of days away from Veterans Day. Kaufman, the defensive end for Northern Illinois. A special story, guys. 26-year-old Marine, Iraq war vet, thought he was going to retire from college football. At that age, he thought his body just wasn't going to take another season, decided to come back, and boy, are the Huskies glad he did.
He's such a solid player, relentless guy. It's good to see him out there.
Adonis Thomas out of the backfield, has the first down, breaking tackles, big gainer for Thomas.
Well, this is exactly what Toledo needs. Adonis Thomas, nice physical run, breaking some tackles. I mean, this is how you extend drives. This is how you get first downs. Any way you can, playmakers got to make plays. This is exactly what Toledo needs right now.
This time, Thomas running the football, nowhere to go. It's going to be a loss of three as Kraus, the nose tackle, is there for the stop. There's a look at Kaufman again, the Mac West Defensive Player of the Week, four tackles, and a game-saving interception against Western Michigan with 39 seconds left. This guy not only is an inspiration, he can play too.
Yeah, you know, it really provides some perspective, obviously, with Veterans Day this week and, you know, all the things that you go through as a football player and preparing for the game. He can tell these guys some real stories.
Owens has time, tipped. As Eric Page couldn't haul it in, incomplete. So to bring up third down and long.
Now you come into a game like this with such a slim margin of error. If you're Toledo and you look at the film the next day and you can go back to maybe two, three, four plays when a game gets away from you. And there are plays like a wide open receiver on a post route or missing a short field goal. But it only takes a couple of those plays before Northern Illinois is able to run away from you. And Toledo right now is on the ropes.
Ten of their 21 plays have gone for no yards or less. And Owens is being chased here. Got it away downfield. Incomplete. No flag. Jerome Jones, the intended receiver. Kaufman with the pressure.
And Kaufman was the one that really collapsed the pocket. And he doesn't quite have the quickness to get to Owens, but he shortens the play.
To watch Owens, it's just so impressive. It just accelerates so quickly. And, of course, running to his left, a lot easier for a left-hander to throw that ball. But he had some zip on that thing. Probably should have been caught.
Yeah, it was a nice ball on the full run and almost connected.
Third punt for Vince Penza. And Tommy Davis going to field this on the hop, and then he's immediately brought down at the 25-yard line. 43-yard kick for Vince Penza. Let's go to Ryan Burren. Tell us what's coming up at halftime.
You got it. Coming up at the half, we will have the latest on Dan Hawkins out of Colorado. Joe Shad will give us the possible replacement candidates with the Buffaloes. Plus, the latest on Cam Newton, the cheating allegations when he was at the University of Florida. We'll uncover that. Plus, the Miami Heat hosting the Utah Jazz. LeBron and the gang in action. It's all coming up on the Halftime Report. We'll see you in a few.
All right, Ryan, thank you very much. Guys, Cam Newton, the first report still under investigation about the pay-for-play situation. Now a new report that Newton faced expulsion from Florida for cheating. This thing's starting to get ugly.
Looks like Toledo in the neutral zone there.
Yeah, Auburn's a rival in Florida making those reports, obviously. And, you know, the SEC, it seems like those guys down there, they love to call each other out.
Offside, defense, number 97, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
And so Melvin Riley, the defensive tackle.
But you always have to be careful there. You know, as they say, people that live in glass houses.
Well, and the athletics director for Auburn coming out and saying they're not going to stoop to that level and that Cam Newton is fully eligible both athletically and academically. And I wonder if this is going to create a distraction for both Cam Newton and Auburn, a team that's looking to get into that title game.
Harnish pushing the pile. Somebody try to tell Harnish he's playing on a bad knee.
I'm not sure he'll listen to you. And this is a guy that came into the game with 559 yards on the ground. The top passer in the conference. Another zone read, and he really knows where to take the ball when he keeps.
He's just got such powerful legs. Runs with great leverage, great body lean. Almost looked like a running back there.
Four guys trying to tackle him, trying to strip that ball. 225 straight running plays now for this team without a fumble. And another one here for Chad Spann. There's C-Spann picking up the first down.
Well, those are impressive numbers, really. When you run the zone read, it's so difficult not to put the ball on the ground sometimes because the quarterback gets caught between handing the ball off. The running back doesn't know if he's going to be taking it or if the quarterback's going to keep it. We saw a play earlier in the ball game. Chad Spann looked like he actually leaned back and went along with Harnish so that they wouldn't put the ball on the ground.
Well, it's really one of the negatives of the spread offense. And we were talking about Oregon earlier. If anything ends up getting the Ducks, it might be the high-risk nature of this offense, handling the ball, the pitches, the shovel passes, and the zone read handoff.
Jordan Lynch checking in at quarterback, and he's going to run too. Bounces off a tackler, and he shows what he can do carrying the football. Archie Donald finally brings him down, but it's a gain of 8 yards first.
As you said earlier, it's so good to have another quarterback that can do this kind of thing in your offense. You still get the advantage with having an extra blocker with wildcat-type looks, but you don't expose your starting quarterback to all the type of hits that you get running this offense. That's another danger that you have, not just with Cam Newton, but with Darren Thomas. Of course, Cam Newton's so big, he's bigger than most of the guys trying to tackle him.
Toledo knows what's coming. They can't stop. Second down and two, low snap. And that play was ugly right from the get-go as Spann is dumped. Malcolm Riley in there for the tackle and a loss of 2 yards.
And with the numbers that Toledo plays on the line of scrimmage, you're going to have some canceled plays. There are going to be some negative plays just by virtue of Toledo selling out to stop the run. And that was one of those plays there, penetration in the backfield.
So now third down and four. Clock is coming up on a minute to go. Northern Illinois tonight, 5 for 6 on third downs. And a penalty flag.
This is a situation, if you're Toledo, where you could use some timeouts on a third down and maybe...
False start. Number 81, offense. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
So Nathan Palmer maybe save some ticks on the clock by using timeout, but... with just a minute to go and Toledo not having a lot of success, I think their primary focus is to get into the locker room, not down by more than 21 points.
Yeah, it's really not the type of situation when you're on the road like this. Even if you get the ball back with less than a minute, you're going to have it deep in your territory. You don't really want to take the chance of taking shots anyway.
And you could extend the drive for Northern Illinois pretty easily as well.
After the first penalty of the night for the Huskies, they want to throw. Harnish, complete. Into Toledo territory at the 48-yard line, Landon Cox, a gain of 12.
Harnish is a pretty good reason why you don't use a timeout there, too, the way that he can make plays. And again, using his feet to set up the accuracy with his arm.
Cox did a nice job adjusting to that ball as well. Kreider in the backfield. Harnish throws again. Another man wide open, this time Willie Clark. Inside the 30. Clock stops with 26 seconds to play.
Well, we talked to Matt Linegrover, the offensive coordinator, Robert, and he said that the offensive line's only given up a few sacks this season, but Harnish has done so many things to help the offensive line with his timing.
We step aside. Northern Illinois leading big, looking for more late in the half.
University of Transformation. Opportunity. Leadership.
The University of Environment. Development. An optimum quality of life. The University of Toledo. Higher education has never been more relevant.
Folks, it's going to be fun in the swamp on Saturday night. Steve Spurrier returns for his 23rd-ranked Gamecocks take on Urban Meyer's Gators for the SEC East title and a trip to Atlanta on the line. South Carolina, they lost to Arkansas last week. David, you've seen Florida the last couple of games, and it seems like they're getting hot at the right time.
They've gotten some playmakers back. Rainey coming off the five-game suspension has been absolutely electric. They don't have Demps at 100%, but guys like Deontay Thompson and Frankie Hammond, that team is loaded, and I think they're going to win that football game.
Northern Illinois on first down and 10. Draw play. Harnish steps up. First down. Slips away. Touchdown. Chandler Harnish. Yard touchdown run for Harnish, and Northern Illinois really demoralizing Toledo late in the half. Celebrating its sixth year sponsoring the Good Hands Field Goal Nets, Allstate making a contribution to participating universities' general scholarship funds for each field goal and extra point kick. To date, $2.3 million in scholarship money. And it's a 28-0 lead, Northern Illinois, with 20 seconds to go here before halftime.
Oh, what a great run by Chandler Harnish. Such a talented player. Had some guys in position to make some blocks downfield for him, and he got to the defenders before his blockers had a chance to even get to some of these guys.
Yeah, and watch the motion, man. They're gonna get some blockers released down the field, and then Harnish is gonna take it and just split it. And he shows me some speed that we might not have known he had coming into this football game. He's got a little burst to him when he gets out in the open field.
I think some of those defenders didn't realize he was running that fast either. It's like they just didn't realize what angle they needed to take. The Harnish just blew right by him.
Four touchdown drives in the half here for Northern Illinois. Three of them have been for 74 yards. Exactly 74 yards.
And 74 yards puts them in their comfort zone.
Yeah, keeping it simple. They know we're not very good at arithmetic up here. Fifth rush touchdown of the year for Harnish. His 11th career rushing touchdown. He has been an inspiration for this Northern Illinois team tonight, which is going to have a big lead going into the locker room. Isaiah Ballard battling his way toward the 35-yard line, and he is punished. And that coverage team, which is inspired right now, and there is the ringleader of the group. Talked about 21 seniors playing their final game at home here tonight for Northern Illinois, and you think about what this senior class has accomplished here in DeKalb. They're going to be going to a bowl game for the third straight year. That's a first in program history.
When Jerry Kill keeps this up, there are going to be some major conference programs knocking at his door. 3 years, three bowl games, and maybe a MAC championship to show for it after this season.
Adonis Thomas. And he'll take it into Northern Illinois territory. And the clock stops with 3 seconds to go.
It's always good to get those end of half carries to pad those yards per carry.
You were always production-oriented, Robert. I knew that would be important to you.
Well, in this series, Toledo leads 29-8, winning 14 of the last 16 games. And the Rockets have played very well here in DeKalb. They're 11-6 overall, but tonight, Northern Illinois saying, oh, no, you don't. You're not going to come in here and work us over, especially with so much on the line. Northern Illinois just came out ready to play.
We talk about balance offensively, all the things that Illinois can do to you, and primarily you have to focus on stopping Chad Spann. But defensively, this is a really good team. I mean, you got a team that's very good in all three facets of the game in Northern Illinois.
Yeah, and they've already beaten Temple. That could be a preview of the MAC championship there. I talk about a coach that's been mentioned in some job openings or possible job openings. Al Golden, one of those guys over there at Temple.
Of course, next Tuesday night on ESPN2, Ohio and Temple for a big game in the MAC East. Both of those clubs 5-1.
We could take a crack here, and it looks like Toledo looking for a Hail Mary potential.
Owens gets the throw away, and it's going to sail through the end zone. There are flags down, and the half cannot end on a penalty flag.
Well, this is going to have to be a hold because it certainly wasn't a catchable ball. I mean, that ball was thrown up the berm 15 yards deep behind the end line.
I think the referees are having that discussion right now. It looks like they were going to call some sort of interference, but
let's take a look.
There's no foul on the play. The pass was uncatchable. That's the end of the first half.
Well, you could call a hold there, but uncatchable ball by about 15 to 20 yards. And not a lot to be excited about if you're a Toledo fan.
295 total yards of offense for Northern Illinois and touchdowns in four of their five drives. Now let's join Ryan Burr and Joe Shad in the studio for a halftime report.
All right, guys, thanks so much. So Northern Illinois making a statement to the Mid-American Conference, 28-0 over the Rockets at the half. Ryan Burr, Joe Shad with you, and a lot to get to on this busy Tuesday in college football. At the University of Colorado, their head coach is out. Dan Hawkins fired as the head coach today of the Buffaloes, effective immediately. His longtime assistant coach, Brian Cabral, will take over as the new head coach. Athletic director Mike Bone said the school's financial constraints mean they won't be able to pursue just anyone. In fact, about $4 million annually to some big-name coaches, they will not be in the running. So, Joe, I'll ask you, who are some guys that could be in the running for the Buffs?
Well, how about 70-year-old Bill McCartney? Hasn't coached since 1994, did once lead the Buffs to a national title. There are a lot of boosters, Ryan, who would like to see a return to glory, a blast from the past. With Bill McCartney, it sounds like he would take the job if offered. Mike Bellotti, our colleague, you know he's had great success in the Pac-10 if he wants to return to college football. Troy Calhoun, great success at Air Force, just up the road, of course. And Jim.
Do these guys fit the financial constraints?
Well, you know, Bellotti might cost a pretty penny. You're right. There are financial constraints, and that could be a factor for somebody like Bellotti.
Looking at Colorado for Hawkins, why didn't this work out?
Well, the easy answer is his players weren't good enough. To go a little deeper, his best recruits didn't pan out. He had a decent amount of recruits that just never lived up to expectations. Also, the philosophy he brought over from Boise State, the whole Hawk love, Zen philosophy, Phil Jackson love fest kind of thing, it never really translated to Colorado in the Big 12. Many people think that, in general, Colorado will be a better fit for the Pac-10. And finally, Dan Hawkins' decision to bring Cody Hawkins in, his son, he pretty much admits it was a mistake. It just didn't work out. Team chemistry wasn't there with his son as the quarterback.
Now Colorado now moving in a new direction. When we return, we check out on the direction the Auburn Tigers go with their star Cam Newton, allegation surfacing that he cheated while at the University of Florida. Stay with us.
But I'm standing up here on a very important week trying to defend something that, quite frankly, is garbage.
Many will hear the calling.
Move it!
Yes, sir!
Few will earn the title United States
Prilosec OTC traveled to the front lines of NFL training camp to put our 24-hour frequent heartburn protection to the test for 2 weeks.
People think we're indestructible, but if you're out there and you're feeling burning, it's going to affect the way that you play.
In my world, either you get it done or they're going to find someone to get it done for you.
Prilosec OTC is the one thing I can count on to block my heartburn.
Prilosec OTC is protecting me.
Take your own 14-day challenge. Prilosec OTC. Heartburn gone, power on.
13 progressive universities. 6 diverse states. 23 sponsored championships. More than 100 academic All-American athletes. 11 College Hall of Fame coaches. Millions of dedicated fans. One great conference. The Mid-American Conference. The new mark of excellence.
Your father's getting out.
He's getting out.
He's going to be paroled.
On the next all-new Friday Night Lights.
Is that why you don't wear a wedding ring?
Look, I like you. It's probably better for both of us if we just...
I totally agree.
Apparently some type of Riley girl initiation. That's Dallas Tinker, Luke Cafferty, and Vincent Howard. Parents want these boys expelled.
Coach, my dad just got out of prison. My mom, she asked me to forgive him. You asked me to be better. I don't know how, because he never taught me.
Friday Night Lights, all new tomorrow on the 101 Network.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema.
These friends are getting back together.
Remember we used to come here after we got wasted?
What's wasted?
When you have a hankering for ice cream.
I want to get chocolate wasted.
And giving parents a bad name.
Turns urine blue.
No, it's an old wives' tale, sweetie.
Oh, my God!
Movies start at channel 125.
Auburn quarterback Cam Newton has taken the spotlight of the college football world all to himself this year, putting up ridiculous numbers as the quarterback of the Tigers. It's a spotlight of another kind that now shines on Newton, as reports from FoxSports.com say that Newton was caught cheating 3 times at the University of Florida and faced expulsion before he finally transferred to a junior college. Newton today addressing these allegations.
Now, I'm not going to entertain something that, you know, took place, well, not 3 months, you know, not 6 months, not even a year, you know, 2 years ago. You know, I'm not going to sit up here and say anything about it, whether I did or did not do it, you know, because I think I don't want to, you know, beat a dead horse, you know, talking about it, because, you know, it's not going to affect me no way, shape, form, or fashion.
He has done everything we have asked him to do since the day he stepped on campus at Auburn. So I want to make this very clear, because I'm wasting my time addressing allegations that completely, to be frank, blow my mind. But I'm standing up here on a very important week trying to defend something that, quite frankly, is garbage. So this is a waste of my time, but I'm going to address it because I'm defending a young man who deserves it. Let me tell you something. He's one of the leaders in the Heisman race because he deserves it. Cameron's going to be focused on playing Georgia this week. Nothing's changed in terms of who he is and what he is, but he is like our son here, and I've got a problem with it. Got a problem with it.
And strong words from the Auburn coach, and Joe, we bring you back in here. I mean, this kind of thing we more see in political ads. You know, one candidate searching for things of another candidate. You don't see it in a Heisman race necessarily. But unfortunately for Newton, the stuff is out there now, and it's guys like you that report on the sport. It's your job to go and see if this stuff, if there's any credence to it. With that said, where do we go from here now that the stuff is out there?
Well, in terms of the Heisman situation, I mean, I think that it would be naive to suggest that these reports, the multiple reports, the knowledge that Cam Newton was involved in the possession of a stolen laptop, the reports that Cam Newton's departure from Florida involved allegations of academic cheating, and the cloud of suspicion surrounding his recruitment process currently being invested by the NCAA will not have some impact on voters. Of course it will. And one of the things I know is that one of the stated missions of the Heisman Trophy Trust is the word integrity. And there is no doubt that Heisman Trophy voters, especially in the wake of the Reggie Bush situation, where a guy actually had to pack up his Heisman Trophy, put it in the mail, and send it back to New York, that will be a factor. Ryan, I think the thing that we have to realize, though, is that this investigation is probably going to take months, if not years.
Right.
Which means that when I fill out my ballot, I'm not going to know a resolution. I'm going to have to make a decision based on what I know happened and what I believe.
Okay. Well, you brought it up. You do have a Heisman vote, so I'll ask you that vote is due today, hypothetically. Which way are you going?
Well, I'm glad it's not. As of right now, Ryan, I would say that I would vote for Cam Newton. I would say that he is clearly the most outstanding player of the year in college football. He has been the story of the year, as you said, in college football. He is a dominant athlete. He is a better passer than anyone realized. He is an unbelievably determined, aggressive rusher. If it was not for Cam Newton, Auburn would not be undefeated. They would not be in line to play for the national championship. That's what it says on the ballot, most outstanding player. It also says the player must be eligible. And it is a fact that as of right now, Cam Newton is an eligible student athlete. What voters fear is whether or not at some point down the line, it could turn out that he's ruled retroactively ineligible.
Well, you said this could be months away, and I put you on the spot there saying the thing was due today. It's not. You're going to have some time here. But with that said, listening to Cam Newton, it was a little Mark McGuire before the Senate there. He wasn't confirming or denying other to say, we're not going back there. I'm not telling you what happened.
Let's be honest. The allegation that he
was caught cheating.
Yeah, well, printed a term paper off of the internet. I mean, is far less serious, far less egregious than allegations that he or someone in his family may have taken extra benefits as part of a pay-for-play scenario. Again, totally unproven, just allegations that are being investigated. But those allegations are far more serious than whether he copied off of someone's paper.
Yeah, and it's, you know, especially leading up to that huge game in Tuscaloosa, this will not be the last time we bring this up. This is a story that is not going to go away, much like you would see in a political election coming to college football. A lot more still to come on this halftime report when we come back. Oregon's depth chart at the quarterback position, not exactly a whole lot of experience, plus Virginia Tech star might miss the game. We're back after this.
I just want you to be loved. Oh, oh.
YP lets you do less searching and more living. YP.com. Click less, live more.
Welcome back to the Halftime Report. Ryan Bird, Joe Shad, all Northern Illinois in the first half. Chad Spann, the touchdown there. Huskies up 28-0 on the Rockets at the break. Let's get to some injury updates. Working backup quarterback Nate Costa will need season-ending surgery because of a right knee injury suffered in last Saturday's victory over Washington. The team came forth with that information today. So what does this mean for number one Oregon? Well, Joe, when you look at the numbers, it means there's not a whole lot of backup there behind Darren Thomas, who's having a spectacular year for the Ducks. But you can look at the guys, they've yet to throw a pass.
As long as Darren Thomas stays healthy, Chip Kelly's okay.
But I guess you could say the same thing at Auburn or say the same thing at Boise State. I mean, they need their stars to stay healthy. So hopefully for the Ducks' case, they'll be okay. Adam Robinson at Iowa suffered a mild concussion in Week 9, set out the Indiana game last week. Sophomore says that he will likely be back for this weekend's tilt against Northwestern. Freshman Marcus Coker led the team in rushing last week as the Hawkeyes squeaked by Indiana. Virginia Tech's athletic trainer says their tailback and kickoff returner David Wilson has been sidelined with mono. Wilson averaging about 29 yards per carry on the backup. On the kickoffs, will likely miss this weekend's game.
He wears a bow tie to class. Did you know that?
I did not know that. And this guy does not wear a bow tie. Matt Gloin taking over as Penn State starting quarterback against Ohio State. The former walk-on has thrown 7 touchdowns in the last 3 games as Joe Paterno goes for win number 401. Won't be easy against Ohio State, but McGloin, one of the real good stories right now in college football.
Talk about exceeding expectations. I mean, if you watch Penn State's spring game, you looked at Rob Bolden, the freshman, and you said, this is what it's all about. Look at the speed, look at the athleticism, look at the big arm. That guy's the future of Penn State football. And then it turns out that McGloin had more confidence, more poise, a stronger arm, better efficiency than anyone ever could have imagined. It really is a great story. Kind of a typical Joe Paterno.
How does he end up walking on a pen? I mean, why didn't anyone see this great arm you're telling me about?
I don't know, but I know that he's in a good spot right now.
He is in
a very... he can hand the ball to Evan Royster, and he can throw it better than people realized.
And he's looked good so far. We'll see how he looks against the Buckeyes. That will be his stiffest test of the year, that is for sure. Speaking of tough tests, how about taking on LeBron in Miami? That's what the Jazz have to do tonight. We'll check in on the Heat when we return on the Halftime Report.
What do you see yourself doing 1 week, 1 month, 5 years after you do retire?
Client comes in and they have a box. And inside that box is their financial life.
People wake up and realize, I'd better start doing something.
We open up that box, we organize it, and we make decisions.
We really are here to help you.
They look back and think, wow, I never thought I could do this, but we've actually done it.
Visit Ameriprise.com and put a confident retirement more within reach.
Close enough just isn't good enough. If your car is in an accident, make sure it's repaired with the right replacement parts. Take the scary out of life with Travelers. Call or click now for an agent or quote.
Well, everything looks good. We've got your car in stock. Let's just check out your credit score and we'll work out your financing.
All right, sounds good.
Did you know everyone has 3 credit scores? And just 1 bad score could really hurt you.
Whoa! That's gonna be a problem.
What do you mean?
Your credit score could be affected by inaccuracies, outdated information, or even identity theft. Now tracking your score is easy at freescore.com. Unlike other services that only provide 1 score, freescore.com lets you see all 3 credit scores for free. And that's important because a single bad score could cause you to be denied a loan, pay higher interest rates, and spend more for the things you want. So get all 3 scores for free at freescore.com. Plus, you'll get unlimited access to your complete credit profile, 24/7 credit alerts, and the quickest way to spot inaccuracies at all 3 credit bureaus.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
One place, 3 scores. Get your scores now at freescore.com.
Free score! Freescore.com!
An American soldier.
Hey, you guys out there who are taking care of us and putting your lives on the line, God bless you. We're with you. Appreciate everything you're doing. And hopefully you'll all come home soon.
ESPN observes Veterans Day tomorrow and Thursday. Catch Mike and Mike 0600 hours from the Coast Guard Sector Key West on ESPN Radio and ESPN2. Then on Veterans Day, join SportsCenter live from Germany, 9 a.m. Special coverage honoring all the branches of the military and its unique connection with the world of athletics. Be with us on Thursday for a very special day on ESPN. Speaking of special, how about the Heat? LeBron James, Dwayne Wade taking on the Jazz. Now, Joe Shad, you spent 9 years in the Sunshine State. Are you a fan of the Heat?
I have been to Heat games, okay. And I'm a fan of Udonis Haslam, because I lived in Gainesville when he was in Florida.
Chris Bosh knocking down the jumper 11-7 early on. Second quarter now, LeBron finding James Jones, who hits the three. 51-32, Heat looking good at 5-2. Just a reminder, a big Wednesday doubleheader on ESPN. The Jazz visit the Magic, so they head up the state, take on Orlando, then the nightcap, the Clippers and the Spurs, 9:30 on ESPN. College baskets tonight. Last year, arguably the biggest upset of the year, Lemoyne College upset Syracuse. Then SU went on to advance all the way to the Sweet 16. There will be no upset tonight. James Sutherland knocking down the three ball. Then it's the freshman C.J. Fair in the lane. Little curl move to the basket, up and in. 91-48, orange all over Lemoyne. Game we're watching right now, all Northern Illinois at the half. Chandler Harnish, big reason why. The quarterback, Colin, his own number 28 zip over the Rockets. Does Toledo have a comeback? We'll find out next second half action.
Way to go, Jared.
You've done it.
Congrats, Jared.
You are an inspiration to everyone.
Jared finished the marathon, and to celebrate, we're offering the Protein Pack Subway Club, one of Jared's low-fat favorites, as a $5 foot-long sub.
Subway. Train hard, eat fresh.
World's manliest rituals.
Axe sent me here to lead you through the rituals around the world to find out what gets the ladies. Axe's pit-pit chest ritual.
Pit-pit chest.
Or other exotic rituals from across the globe.
Watch the show at funnyordie.com.
AT&T introduces a new Windows phone. With stage presence. A new phone with Dolby Surround sound speakers. Only from AT&T. Rethink possible.
It's like a blast of hydration. The new Schick Hydro. Water-activated gel hydrates your skin as you shave, and skin guards reduce irritation. It's the best shave for your skin. Schick Hydro. Free your skin.
Respectful competitors. We are loyal fans. We are gracious in victory and demonstrate poise in defeat. We are leaders on the field and in the stands. We are champions in sport and in life. We are the Mid-American Conference, the new mark of excellence.
ESPN College Football Primetime back at DeKalb, Illinois. First place on the MAC West on the line here tonight. But this has been a one-sided affair through 30 minutes. Northern Illinois with five possessions in that first half, four touchdowns. Robert Smith, David Norrie, Clay Matvick back with you, and we've been impressed by the Huskies. Robert, it's been hard to see anything that's going to slow this running offense down.
Yeah, and they've been impressive all season long. Number one in the conference in rush offense, scoring offense, total offense. Problem is, they just put so much pressure on a defense because they're so balanced.
Chandler Harnish has become a dual threat.
Well, if he keeps on playing at this level, they're not only going to go to the MAC championship game, but they're going to win that MAC championship game. First half, he throws for 120 yards, 9 for 12 passing, and he runs for 78 yards. He's averaging close to 10 yards a carry.
Let's take a look at the highlights from the first half. And the opening drive made a statement here tonight for Northern Illinois.
Yeah, and Chad Spann, such a powerful back. Not very big, but he has great lateral movement. Really moves around well. A lot of fun to watch.
Yeah, this is a bunch route. They hit Palmer down the numbers. Beautiful ball from Harnish. And Harnish pressing all the buttons. He's been exceptional with his decisions in the zone read game. And when he pulls the ball on the zone read, he knows exactly where to attack.
Harnish has got over 6,000 total yards for his career. His effort here tonight. And Toledo, they've got a big hole to climb out of. This is the largest halftime lead of the season for Northern Illinois. Eric Page is back to return this kick from Michael Klimovsky. Yeah. a step deep in the end zone. Page. Good start for Toledo. They have good field position at the 35-yard line. Now tonight's game track brought to you by Fidelity Investments.
You're taking a look at the game track. All Huskies in the first half, and it really could have been worse. Toledo had a couple opportunities early. They missed the ball down the center of the field on the post route for the touchdown. It's been all Huskies ever since.
Well, you're going to learn a lot about this team here in the second half. Only two seniors out of the starters on this offense, and they really need to get something done. We're going to see what Terrence Owens and the rest of this offense can do.
Owens 6 for 16, 65 yards passing in the first half. And he is incomplete on his first attempt here of the second half. Tim Cortozzo, the intended receiver, and Owens has now missed 7 of the last 8 passes.
And I'm not a big fan of those kinds of routes where you're throwing the ball all the way across the field to maybe pick up 3 or 4 yards. It's dangerous. It's a flat kind of angle on the pass. And you give a cornerback an opportunity to go the other way for a touchdown.
And a young quarterback, it's a tough throw to make in the first place. And he's been struggling, so you don't want to put too much on him at this point.
Second down and 10. Opening possession of the half for Toledo. Down 4 touchdowns. In his first career start at quarterback. Cox's arm fires and incomplete along the near sideline. Page was there. Check that, Bernard Reedy, the intended receiver. And it'll bring up 3rd down. And the last thing Toledo wants to do here right out of the gate is go 3 and out of the opening series.
But just like David said, you know, those kind of throws to start off the half like that, you really got to question that. You want to have some nice manageable 3rd downs, and here you are looking at 3rd and 10 right off the bat.
They converted just once on 3rd down tonight. Owens steps up, wants to run, short of the first down. And the Rockets will have to punt. Devon Butler made the stop, the middle linebacker.
Hey, you might want to give that one to the ref, too. Looked like the ref got in the way a little bit. Terrence Owens had his path blocked a little.
So another way to get 8 in the box.
Yeah, that's a good point.
The umpire.
The Northern Illinois defense stepping up. They've allowed just 7 second-half points in the last 4 games. Got to a good start here in the second half tonight. This bounces at the 12, takes a nice Toledo roll. And it's going to be marked out at the 4-yard line. So a long field here for the Huskies. A 54-yard punt for Pencil.
53-yard punt.
Well, we saw a little bit of everything for Chandler Harnish in that first half.
Yeah, he does it all. And what really impresses me is he does so much offensively. Take a look at the Husky. That's a beautiful animal.
Blue eyes.
It's Husky with an IE, not with a Y like they do up in the Pacific Northwest. But, you know, Harnish does so much offensively, but he takes care of the football, too.
Not like the pants size.
Gun from the end zone, deep handoff for Spann. Spann had 16 carries for 48 yards and a touchdown. No gain on his first carry of the half. Let's take a look at the MAC West standings coming into the night. Northern Illinois and Toledo, both 5-0, the only undefeated teams in the league. And this winner here tonight will be in the driver's seat for the MAC West championship with 2 weeks to go.
And I think in all candor, it's more than the driver's seat. I don't see Northern Illinois losing 2 in a row to finish off the season.
It'll be at Ball State and Eastern Michigan to close it out as Harnish takes it himself.
Run made by Harnish.
Harnish with 4 yards on that run. Here's a look at that remaining schedule for the Huskies. Ball State having a down year, and Eastern Michigan, one of the worst teams in college football.
Well, Ron English finally got his first win there this season. I think he had lost 18 straight to start off his coaching tenure there at Eastern Michigan, so they've had some troubles. And of course, Central Michigan, with Butch Jones now at Cincinnati, Dan Innes in his first season, they've struggled a little bit losing Dan Lefebvre.
And Northern Illinois playing the way they're playing right now, I'm not sure I want to watch either one of those games. Those could be rated NC-17.
Harnish wants a timeout. Just getting underway here in the second half, all Northern Illinois.
Thanksgiving.
That boy they killed is my brother.
If you're on his list,
I'm gonna kill you all.
Then you're already dead. Dwayne Johnson.
God can't save you from me.
But maybe he could save you from yourself. Faster.
Sermon's over.
Rated R.
Mark, we have teams on both coasts that are interested, but Milos only wants to play for Dallas.
By Vizio.
There are just 9 teams in the FBS undefeated in league play, and we're seeing 2 of them here tonight in the MAC, Toledo and Northern Illinois, all Huskies. 12:55 to go here in the third quarter. Robert Smith, David Norrie, Clay Matvick with you. Harnish in trouble in the end zone, and he is going to be sacked. A safety for Toledo. Alex Johnson, the defensive end, making the play.
Alex Johnson's a great story. Broken his orbital bone a number of weeks ago. Just had to be a very painful injury. Back in there playing and saying, hey, if the offense isn't going to score some points, I guess we're going to have to step up and score some points.
Well, and if you could ever take a good safety, this is one right here. I mean, Harnish showing his seasoning, not trying to get the ball out, not fumbling, not forcing the ball. He realizes he's going to take a safety, but it's only 2 points. And with a 28-point lead, Mr. Johnson bearing down on him. That's just a solid play to eat that and live to fight another day.
It's a good call.
Just the 10th sack given up by Northern Illinois' offensive line here this year, and Johnson making the play. Hard to believe. You're right. An amazing story. Only missed a month after breaking that bone around his side.
For some of the stories you hear of endurance and pain tolerance, some players, what they've been through, it's really just phenomenal.
I remember those stories in this football game. We talked about Harnish coming back from a knee injury where at least one specialist said your football career is over. And here he is, the best quarterback of the MAC conference, leading the conference in passing and average yards per carry. We talked about, obviously, Jake Kaufman coming back from 2 tours in Iraq. And then Alex Johnson, a guy who a lot of players would not come back in the season, let alone 3 weeks from a fractured orbital bone.
I would have retired. From the 10, here's Eric Page. Another good return and a marker down as he gets to the 40.
Well, let's face it, Clay, you're not noted for your toughness.
No.
Tackled
by Melvin for
the Huskies. There's a flag on the play.
You're a finesse player.
Holding. Number 46 on the return team. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul.
Man. First down.
Tim Beckman, this team, you can just see the frustration on his face. That's another penalty against Toledo. The second special teams penalty tonight, and the sixth overall.
Well, it's an interesting contrast. They've had a lot of penalties called against them, but they're tied for second in the country with 26 turnovers forced on defense, and they're tied for first with 16 interceptions.
So Toledo's on the board after the safety. And got it back after the free kick. Here's Terrence Owens. Dumps it out in the flat. Adonis Thomas. Good run after the catch. It's a pickup of 9. We've seen that play quite a few times here tonight, and we've seen it with pretty good success at times. It's just they haven't been able to string enough of it together.
I thought that was a well-timed call there by Matt Campbell, the offensive coordinator.
Owens is going to run it himself. He's got the first down, a stiff arm. And he is taken out at the 41-yard line, make it the 42, a 7-yard pickup for Owens.
But we had said on that last drive, kind of questioned the play calling on those first couple plays and the kind of position to put them in. It certainly seems like play calling right here is much more conducive to the type of game that obviously they're going to need to play to put up some points.
Full receiver look here on first down. Thomas lining up to the left of Owens. Has a man downfield. Again, it's Eric Page. Incomplete.
Well, and I really didn't have big problem with the play calls passing the ball on first down, the short passing game. It's just a high degree of difficulty on the throws way out to the sideline, and you're not going to pick up many yards. I mean, I know that the thinking there is you want to set up a 2nd and 6. And then you have some of these shots down the field where Owens is missing wide open wide receivers, and Northern Illinois too good to not be more consistent when you're passing the ball if you're Toledo.
Second down, Owens feeling some pressure, steps up, gets away from the tackler. He's going to get the first down. Good run for Terrence Owens. A gain of 11, and they'll move the sticks.
Well, I'd like to see them use Terrence Owens in the running game some more on first and second down. When he pulls the ball down, whether it's a planned run or improvising, I mean, he might be the most dangerous aspect to this offense when he's running the football.
Yeah, and right there was a called pass, and I think he's just doing a better job of recognizing when the opportunities present themselves to go ahead and take advantage of it. Kind of trusted himself.
Play fake. Owens wants to throw deep down the near sideline, looking for Page again. Well covered, maybe too well covered. Penalty flag down. Patrick George, the right corner, in on the coverage, and maybe a little too touchy feeling.
Defense.
Watching that play with the naked eye, I thought there was way too much contact down the field, and they really had a shot to hit this. Toledo really wanted to get Page more involved, but George using that right arm and kind of a push late. But Toledo really wanted to utilize Page and get him more involved, and they have not done a good job of doing that tonight.
Yeah, you know, George there trying to use that technique really to feel Page, kind of get that hand on the hip so you can feel where he is. But he got those hands up a little bit high, got hooked up with the arms. They're going to call that every time.
On first down from the 32, back to the ground game, and it's Adonis Thomas ripping off a big run up the middle, giving 14, and not Toledo in business in the red zone.
We're seeing two very impressive backs, both for Northern Illinois and Toledo. I obviously like the look, Robert, of Chad Spann, but when Adonis Thomas has any sort of running room, he's pretty explosive.
Yeah, he really is. Runs very low to the ground, compact guy. A bowling ball running down the field. It doesn't present a lot of target for defense. He's got some pretty good acceleration, too.
He'll get it on the sweep. Thomas to the end zone. Touchdown. Adonis Thomas runs it in from 18 yards out, and 10 unanswered points on the board. Check that, 8 unanswered points for Toledo. I can't get ahead of myself here.
Could be 9 quickly.
As they're waking up.
And I like the decision here to not go for 2. Way too early to go for 2 after another great run by Adonis Thomas.
I really like the play call once again. This is what Matt Campbell, the offensive coordinator, had told us coming in. Wanted to really change up the formations, give a lot of multiple tempo. False.
Offsides. Defense. Number five.
False keys, misdirection. Really mixing up the play call in there on that drive. I think it kept that Northern Illinois defense off balance.
Adonis Thomas, who Matt Campbell, the offensive coordinator for Toledo, says has really flourished in recent weeks, giving the Rockets a much-needed spark here in the third quarter, their first touchdown of the night. Klaus is on for the extra point. And Toledo threatening to get back in this one.
Well, they are back in this one. 20 points with over 10 minutes to go in the third quarter.
Fourth touchdown of the year for Thomas, fifth of his career. We've got a game here at the Cal.
Steve Spurrier leads South Carolina against the Gators for a spot in the SEC championship game. South Carolina, Florida, Saturday at 7:15 on ESPN.
Enterprise, hi, I'm at the repair shop. I need to rent a car.
Enterprise will arrange to pick you up.
This is great.
Drive you to our place and get you on your way. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
The new KFC Doubleicious Chicken Sandwich.
I've never seen a sandwich like this before.
With a sweet Hawaiian bun to make those 11 herbs and spices really come to life.
It's sweet.
Savory. Get even more with a side and a drink for just $5.
G-double-O-D good.
So this holiday season, everyone's talking about the Evo, the first 4G phone in the country.
Whoa, this is so fast.
So many things you can do with this phone. Surf the internet, you can stream videos, TV.
That is awesome.
It's for every age group, which is really cool because it's not like just teenagers or just adults. And I get to just be like all excited about it, and then they get excited about it, and then everyone's excited about it.
See the HTC Evo 4G and our complete selection of Sprint smartphones at Best Buy.
All your options, all the phones, all the features. Why would you go anywhere else but Best Buy?
Jack Link's Beef Jerky presents Messin' with Sasquatch.
Hey there, big guy. You know, you look a little tired. Why don't you come over here and sit down? Yeah, come on. That's right, sit down.
Jack Link's Jerky. Feed your wild side.
Oh, well, playing Black Ops yet?
Yeah, it's awesome. I got it at Walmart at midnight.
Me too.
I just stole a Russian Hind attack chopper.
You couldn't steal a Russian attack
tricycle. Look, you better call in some backup reinforcements, man, because I don't go down easy.
Out of the vehicle. Don't need backup and do it all by myself.
The problem is I don't respect you because I've played you, man, and you got nothing on me.
Rated M for mature. Get Call of Duty Black Ops. The best way to play is Xbox 360. The fastest way to play is Walmart. Save money, live better. Walmart.
ESPN's College Football Primetime, brought to you by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. We'll pick you up. And KFC. Try KFC's new Doubleicious Chicken Sandwich on a sweet Hawaiian bun. So good.
Here's Jake Kaufman, the 26-year-old defensive end, a Marine and an Iraq War vet. On senior night, with his folks and 20 other seniors playing their final game here at home tonight. And Northern Illinois, really good shape here with 10:42 to go in the third quarter. But Toledo has come alive. They have scored 9 unanswered points, a safety and a touchdown drive. And here's the statistical oddity of the night. Another 74-yard touchdown drive. There have been 5 drives, 4 by Northern Illinois and 1 for Toledo, that resulted in a touchdown, all of 74 yards.
What are the odds there?
Davis on the return, but there is a marker down.
Flag down on the field.
We'll have to have research check that one for us. Yeah. What are the odds of 5 touchdown drives of exactly 74 yards?
Holding. Receiving team, number 44. 10-yard penalty. First down.
And here's our Building a Program feature brought to you by Craftsman. When we take a look at Toledo, 5-0 in MAC play for the first time since 2004. Tim Beckman, second year as head coach, he's done some wonderful things with the program. They have won three straight road games this season for the first time since 95. They've won four on the road overall. Their only loss on the road was at Boise State, and there's no shame in that.
Now, there aren't many people that win on that blue turf.
So Northern Illinois goes back to work on offense. Pump fake, Harnish rolling out to the near side, throwing across his body, incomplete. Closest to a receiver there was Nathan Palmer, who has a touchdown catch tonight, second down.
Harnish is one of those rare quarterbacks that looks just as comfortable throwing the ball on the move to his left as he does to his strong side, the right side. And on that play, he was intentionally just getting rid of the ball. He didn't like the picture down the field on that two wide receiver combination route.
Northern Illinois minus 4 yards of offense so far in this quarter. Quite a change from the way they were running it up the first 30 minutes. Harnish will run. First down and more.
Look out.
One man to beat. The 30. And run out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. A 69-yard run for Chandler Harnish.
David, you talked about the wheels of Chandler Harnish. What an impressive player. Just takes off, makes some guys miss. Has some wheels, not quite enough wheels to outrun Tyquan Page on that one.
Yeah, Page had a bit of an angle on him. Harnish was doing his best to deliver a stiff arm and get that last 15 yards, but Page angled him.
Jordan Lynch gives him a much needed breather as he comes in a quarterback. And now he'll run. And he'll pick up a few. Chandler Harnish, you saw the numbers for him tonight. He is out producing Toledo's offense all by himself.
Yeah, this is a planned run, and he gets Span leading up into the hole, gets rid of Singer on a nice move. Singer whiffs on the tackle, and Page, from that deep angle in the secondary, wasn't a lot that Harnish was going to do to get around it.
You know, we talked about the way that this defense has been playing, though, and Mike Ward's going to have a lot of things to say. The defensive coordinator there at Toledo is going to have a lot of things to say about these guys. Not playing very good technique, not keeping the correct arm free, not filling the right gaps. They're going to have a long film study tomorrow.
Harnish to the five. Ball pops loose, but they're going to rule him down. That 69-yard run for Harnish, a career long, and I don't think we can tell this story enough about what happened to him. You know, the doctor said, you're going to need surgery, and when you get this surgery, your career might be over. Amazingly, as he was rehabbing, getting ready for the surgery, the rehab started to work, the pain went down, and he decided, you know what, I'm going to pass on the surgery, and his leg gets stronger by the minute.
You don't hear many stories like that, and about 146 yards on the ground tonight.
Cam Newton-type numbers.
Chad Spann waltzes in. Touchdown, Northern Illinois.
Give some credit to this offensive line because they deserve plenty of it tonight. One of the bigger offensive lines that you'll see not only in the MAC but in college football. They go about 312, 313 on average across the front. Olsen and Otis, two very talented tackles. And then Scott Wedge, the bell cow at center. This is an offensive line that's playing with a lot of rhythm.
Spann has scored at least one touchdown in each of the last 9 games. He's got 2 here tonight.
Great job by the offensive line here. Boy, I don't remember too many times I got in the end zone standing up, not being touched. Boy, you can see right there. Great job by that offensive line, even
getting their helmets knocked off. But you know that defense isn't quite doing its job if nobody even lays a hand on the running back from the 5-yard line.
Well, Robert, I remember quite a few runs that you scored where you didn't get touched, but those were, you know, 60, 70, 80-yard runs where people were trying to run you down from behind.
Those are different, though, the goal line situations. Yeah. I'd be off the field inside the 10-yard line. Leroy Horde got all of those carries.
Now the touchdown set up by Chandler Harnish, the big 69-yard run. And how about Toledo? They come out with a couple of quick scores here in the third quarter. Northern Illinois unfazed, big haymaker right back.
Yeah, and Toledo, I mean, you got to hold serve defensively on that possession. You cut the lead to 19 points, 20 points will give you the lead. You're still in the game with more than 10 minutes to go in the third quarter. And Northern Illinois goes through you like a hot knife through butter.
Guys, I got an update. That drive, not 74 yards, it was an 80-yarder. Here's Eric Page. Another solid return. Now Toledo's just going to try and do something with it. He gets across the 30-yard line. A 32-yard pickup on that return for Eric Page. Folks, join ESPN in support of our troops, wounded warriors, and their families. Donate $10 by texting USO to 27722. Or go to USO.org. I know both of you are from military families.
Well, we haven't served. Robert and I haven't served, but we've some fathers and some grandfathers, and that charity, I can't think of a better cause to get on your cell phone and think about more than $10.
Always embarrass me, really, when people call you a hero being a football player when you know so many people in the world are doing so much more important things.
Terrence Owens is toppled by Chris Smith after a pickup of 7.
I like the look of Owens. He reminds me a lot of Patrick White, who was so electrifying a quarterback for West Virginia under Rich Rodriguez. He has a nice ability with the throwing arm. He's missed a few shots tonight, but he's certainly dynamic with the legs as well.
Out of the gun again here on 2nd and 3. First down, Thomas. Another big run for Adonis Thomas, and he may go to the house. Touchdown, Thomas, from 60 yards out.
That, my friend, is hitting it and getting it. Adonis Thomas turned on the wheels, turned on the jets there. Impressive.
They told us he was a one-cut back, and he... He made the cut, took it back to the right across the field, and took the angles away from the entire secondary.
Toledo is making it interesting. A career-long run for Adonis Thomas. He's now got 129 on the ground and a pair of touchdowns.
AT&T introduces a new Windows phone with stage presence. A new phone with Dolby Surround sound speakers. Only from AT&T. Rethink possible.
Going forward, faster, never looking back. Going up, pick it up. Come on.
The energy drink for your feet. With Zaytac, I get more gain, less pain.
Now you can catch ESPN shows like SportsCenter, PTI, and Monday Night Football live online. Find out how at ESPNNetworks.com.
If you've got pain,
You need the patch.
The Icy Hot Patches. Targeted no-mess relief for shoulders, backs, even arthritis. Icy to dull pain, hot to relax it away. Stop pain right at the source. Icy Hot Patches.
Pain's no match for the Icy Hot Patch.
Living with foot pain? Get Gold Bond Pain Relieving Foot Cream. Maximum strength medicine stops pain fast. Gold Bond Pain Relieving Foot Cream. Finally, fast relief for painful feet. And you can massage in mess-free relief with Gold Bond Pain Relieving Foot Roll-On.
Saturday, November 13th, the fight of the year is on. Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao looking to make history and become the sport's first eight-time eight-division world champion. Standing in his way is the biggest and most dangerous opponent yet, Antonio Margarito. Order now, and with the purchase of a 12-pack of Tecate or Tecate Light, receive up to $25 back by mail. Offer ends November 13th, 2010. Must be 21 years of age or older. Other terms apply. Pacquiao versus Margarito. Live Saturday, November 13th on DirecTV Pay-Per-View.
Set your alarm for the College Hoops Tip-Off Marathon. The action starts following Monday Night Football on ESPN. You can catch 21 games over 24 consecutive hours. Signs of the season are everywhere, and we don't mean Christmas. Toledo, their first six drives, 119 yards of total offense and no points. Last two drives, 141 yards of total offense and 14 points.
We'll talk about how young this team is. Really showing a lot of intestinal fortitude here. Second half, you know, you're down 28-0 at halftime. You come out on fire like this. It says a lot about your team and a lot about what Tim Beckman's able to do with these guys.
Tommy Davis runs up to field that kick. Gets across the 30. Good return down at the 40. 21-yard return for Tommy Davis, the sophomore from Northern Illinois. Here's a look at that touchdown.
Well, the cut, putting the left foot in the ground and then taking it all the way back across the field. Watch the block right here that Reedy gets on Sobel. Freeze it. Watch Sobel right here. He's trailing the play, and Bernard Reedy, the true freshman, is going to give him a little wake-up call. And Robert, plenty of speed for Thomas to take it the rest of the way.
Plenty of speed for Reedy to catch all the way up to Sobel and still make the block. Anytime you have a long run like that, there's always a receiver downfield making some sort of big block.
Chandler Harnish. That's his 13th carry tonight. And he's at 148 yards on the ground. That's to go along with his 120 through the air. Second down and 7 coming up. Ricky Kreider is checked in. Harnish to the tight end, Jason Shepler. That's his first catch tonight. And depending on the spot, he might have a first down. A pickup of 8 for Shepler. High school offensive lineman who walked onto this program.
And watch the big arm fake to the left side to set up a little delay route outside to the tight end. That was well drawn up.
Yeah, and Shepler acts like he's going to stay in and block and then gets a nice big hurdle move. Been seeing a lot of that from fullbacks. Haven't seen too many tight ends attempt that one, especially former linemen.
He goes about 6'3", 270 pounds. I'm not sure at that size I'd be getting airborne very often.
Trying to get back down as soon as you can, that's for sure.
It was just his fifth catch of the year. On the end around, Akeem Daniels, another jet sweep for big yards. Nice move at the 10, touchdown, Akeem Daniels. From 50 yards out.
Robert, I know you agree with me on this one. I think this may go upstairs for a review, but is he a change of pace type of guy on that jet sweep? I mean, he caught the entire defense flat-footed.
Yeah, so they're going to take another look at this one. I saw that one live and didn't think that he quite got there. Still going to be his...
is under further review.
It's still going to be his career long. Nice move there. It's so funny. You know, we spoke to offensive coordinator Mike Limegrover, and he said, yeah, he's our jet sweep guy. Like, he wasn't kidding. This is their jet sweep guy. There's no two ways about it.
Watch him put on the brakes, and Deontay Morrow gets taken for a ride.
Looks like he stayed in, boys. What do you think?
Well, he stayed in bounds.
I think he didn't extend the ball. The knee is down.
Exactly. And I don't think they're going to rule that he broke the plane, but it was a great effort. Yeah. And they're going to have to find an angle that illustrates it, or it's going to stay as a touchdown. They can piece it together with a couple different looks, but there's not a lot there that indicates where he is before he crosses the goal line. Maybe this angle.
The replay official is John Corris, and there has to be indisputable visual evidence seen upstairs to overturn the call on the field, which was a touchdown.
Yeah, we haven't really seen a look that it's indisputable. It certainly doesn't look like he had the ball across the plane of the goal line when his knee hit, but there doesn't seem to be any view that shows that conclusively. Whether it gets called a touchdown or not, that is a heroic effort by Akeem Daniels.
It really is. Nice little cutback there. Very tall guy. He's extended as far as he can. Here's another. Oh, yeah, that one might do it right there.
I mean, he barely has the football off his breastplate there, the shoulder pads. He might not have even had the football off his shoulder pads there before his knee was down.
That is going to be the issue.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
So it stands, second career touchdown for Daniels. They have both come here tonight.
Yeah, that's not a mistake in any way by the review booth. They just didn't have an angle that could, you know, it was not indisputable. And therefore, the review booth got it right in my mind.
Klimovsky on for another extra point attempt. And Toledo has shown some spark here in the third quarter, but every time Northern Illinois pushes him right back down.
And even though they got it right, I still didn't think he scored.
Well, if this had been a daytime game, that one may have come back, because with the lights, it looked like the shadow and the combination of the shadows and the black pants, you could not tell conclusively whether or not the knee went down. Anyway, you cut it, though. What a fantastic run, cutting it back, extending the ball.
Shadows.
Glad that he got the touchdown.
Shadows, you're turning this into a CSI episode. And next you bring in the forensic experts.
That one view where we were looking dead on it, and you couldn't tell whether or not his knee was on the ground because, once again, the lights, shadows. I don't know the CSI music, right? Hum it or something.
I'm just trying to guess what the next city they're going to get. Three or four
CSI
cities already.
CSI DeKalb. Maybe in DeKalb.
Klimovsky will kick for the Huskies. Receiving from...
Three plays, 60 yards in a minute, 34 seconds. Another touchdown drive for Northern Illinois.
You guys know why I was excited to come to DeKalb.
First time here?
The hometown of my... No. The hometown of my... The hometown of my favorite supermodel, Cindy Crawford.
That's right.
Now, obviously, she's not here. She's out in Malibu right now. But
and this time, no return for Page as Klimovsky drives it through the end zone. Well, Jerry Kill has got to be feeling really good right now. And physically, we know that he has been feeling better in recent years. He had a bout with kidney cancer about 5 years ago. He was diagnosed while he was the head coach at Southern Illinois, able to beat the cancer. And he says it's actually the best thing that ever happened to him. He and his wife, Rebecca, and the folks at Southern Illinois have set up a fund for cancer research. Quite a story. And he's done a great job with this program. Holmes, down he goes at the 15. A loss of five on the sack for Sean Brogard.
Well, it's one of the more moving stories that we've seen in college football, to kidney cancer, And to come back, he's cancer-free, and all the things that he's doing, as he said to us on the phone the other day, to help people that don't have the ability to pay for their cancer treatment.
First sack of the night for this Northern Illinois defense, 15th of the year. Puts Owens in his offense in a second and 15. He's going to try and run, gets back close to the original line of scrimmage. Third down. There's Jake Kaufman again, guys, making the tackle. He has played pretty well tonight as well.
Oh, new life for Jake Kaufman, and survived great adversity, and obviously his coach, Jerry Kill, as well. Such an inspirational story, and when you've been through something like that, that type of adversity, literally a new lease on life. You see things with completely different eyes.
Picked off. Rashawn Melvin.
These are the situations that Toledo did not want to put their young quarterback in such a big ball game. And he's going to take a shot on a corner route to Julian Bellinger, number 83. And this ball just hangs up too long. When you throw the corner route, you got to get the ball out over the underneath defender, but you also have to account for the safety coming over the top.
Well, I think the helmet just popped off there.
Yeah, if he'd
Melvin with
off,
his little celebration.
If he had taken it off himself, it would have been a penalty, but it popped off when he was bouncing around down there. Harnish, he wants to go up top for the big play. Caught. Martell Moore. No, that's Perez Ashford with the catch. A 35-yard gain.
What a great catch by Ashford here. This is a ball that very easily could have been intercepted as well. Just goes up, catches the ball cleanly, extends his hands away from his body, doesn't try and get his body, doesn't try and catch it with his chest. Just gets those hands extended, makes an excellent catch.
That was a great play by Harnish, though, to kick the ball on him that quickly.
Inside handoff, here is Spann. He's going to be close to a first down, a gain of 9 for Chad Spann.
You watch a great play like that last reception by Ashford, and sometimes the throw gets lost in the mix, but Harnish, because he gets the ball out with such great timing and he gets the ball on his receiver so quickly, Byron Best, the guy playing cornerback, is not able to react to it, and you really give the advantage to your wide receiver with that type of timing and accuracy on a deep ball.
Harnish picks up the first. 316 yards rushing tonight. Second 300-yard rushing game of the year for Northern Illinois. And look at what Chandler Harnish has done. 149 yards on the ground, 162 through the air, a pair of touchdowns, one rushing, one passing.
Yeah, he's played close to a perfect game. I remember one ball that he missed that he should have hit, but he has been spotless.
First down and goal. Another touchdown for Chad Spann. 8-yard touchdown run for Spann. Ties a career high, his third touchdown of the game.
I'll tell you, this Northern Illinois team is impressive. Toledo started to fight their way back into it, but they never let off the gas. They just keep putting pressure on you.
Team Northern Illinois. Let's get a sports center right now. Here's Ryan Burke.
Thanks so much. The University of Colorado announced this morning that Dan Hawkins has been relieved of his duties as the head coach of the Buffaloes effective immediately. Longtime assistant head coach Brian Cabral will be the new man in charge. FoxSports.com reporting that Auburn quarterback Cam Newton faced possible expulsion from the University of Florida for academic cheating when he transferred to a junior college in the spring of 2009. Auburn coach Gene Chizik called the allegations, quote, garbage. SportsCenter currently on ESPN News. Guys.
All right, Ryan, thank you very much. Back here at the Cal. There's Chad Spann. Big smile on his face.
He's still going.
He's got three touchdowns tonight. Yeah, he's not even going to take a few minutes off. He goes right to the bike.
Did they give you extra yards on that?
Yeah. Another.
Chris, your total.
Another good job by Joe Pavlov pulling around. Agile guy for 6'5", 301.
We talked to Mike Ward, the defensive coordinator for Toledo, and that was one of the things that worried him about this offensive line, not just the size, as we look at Ward, who made the interception, but not just the size of this offensive line, but the athleticism and guards and a center who can get up and move and lead the way.
2.5 to go here in the third quarter, all Northern Illinois. Eric Page trying to spark Toledo. Another excellent return. He is going to have a big night statistically in the return game. As he gets out close to midfield. College football primetime continues on ESPN and ESPN2 Thursday night at 7:30 Eastern on ESPN. It's Pitt and UConn. Then on ESPN2 Friday at 9, Kellen Moore leads fourth-ranked Boise State against Idaho. College football on ESPN Thursday and ESPN2 on Friday.
Well, Boise's going to have their opportunity to impress some voters. Maybe not with the schedule necessarily, but at least they're going to be playing on national TV like three of the four next weeks. That Nevada matchup should be pretty interesting in a couple weeks.
Adonis Thomas having a great second half. He's got a first down and more running through tacklers and gets to the 30-yard line of Northern Illinois. That's a 21-yard run for Thomas.
Nice patient run by Adonis Thomas there. Just stops his feet in the backfield, cuts back across the field, and doesn't give up. Gets a few extra yards by making somebody miss at the end of the run.
Can't step out of an ankle tackle there. He'll pick up two more.
I think we have a couple backs at the very least in this game in Spann and Adonis Thomas that could play for any team across the country and get quality carries. I mean, these guys are top-notch backs.
Thomas now 152 on 10 carries and a pair of touchdowns. He can catch it too. Inside the red zone, brought down by Krause.
When we talked to Matt Campbell, the offensive coordinator this week, he said he's our spark plug. He's absolutely flourished in the last two games. It looks like he's slow getting up here.
Well, he was getting pulled down there. Looked like someone just fell on that foot. Sometimes your foot gets caught in the turf and somebody falls right on the back of your heel, pushes that thing to the side. A lot of times you can...
Such a great combination of a run threat. We saw it on the home run, the touchdown, the long touchdown run. And you see he gets pinned from behind there. But he's a very talented back catching the ball coming out of the backfield.
And he's walking off on his own power. That's a good sign. As Toledo has already lost their starting quarterback, Austin Danton, to a shoulder injury for potentially the rest of the season. They think he could come back for a bowl game. They couldn't afford to lose this guy down the stretch.
Yeah, it looks like he's got a little hitch in that giddy up there. That thing's probably going to be pretty sore. Stick that in the old ice bucket tomorrow in the next couple days and try and get it back. Going to have a lot of time before their next game.
Morgan Williams checks in for Thomas. On first down, quick hitter. Caught at the 21. Here's Page making his way inside the 10. Good run after the catch down at the 6-yard line. Yeah, Eric Page is an excellent receiver. Gain of 13. I'm sorry.
Sorry, Clay. You know, it's interesting, Robert, when you're playing the game of football, and we just saw Adonis Thomas come off slowly, but the morning after was always a time where you kind of assess what injuries you had because some of them wouldn't show up, the soreness, until you woke up the next day.
Williams. And a
It's going to bring up second down and goal from the three.
Well, you're right, David. I mean, you're so jacked up on adrenaline in the course of a game. It's so funny. You see what some of the players endure, and you see them on the sideline getting dislocations, put back into place. And who was it? Ronnie Lott getting the tip of his finger cut off. You know, certainly you pay for it the next day, but it's a lot easier to deal with on the game day.
Wants to throw to the end zone. Caught for a touchdown. Eric Page. 3-yard touchdown reception. And it's the third touchdown here in the second half for Toledo.
You get a look at Tim Beckman on the sideline, and I think what he'd tell you after this game, and that certainly after film study, if Toledo could have played offense with this efficiency in the first half, it would have been a different game. They've really moved it at will here in the second half, but too little too late.
And Klaus with the extra point. 49-23 now here with 38 seconds to go in the third. This is the fifth touchdown reception of the year for Page.
And just a little quick three-step drop, short passing game. Page wins the battle, the inside. Once you get inside the defensive back, as long as the quarterback can put it on you, that's a touchdown.
Let's take a look at our Life's Good flashback brought to you by LG. Let's go back to October of last year. Northern Illinois taking the lead in the game against Toledo in the fourth quarter. But the Rockets came right back to go ahead by a point. DeJuan Collins with the touchdown run. Came down to 37 seconds left. A 42-yard Northern Illinois game-winning field goal attempt blocked by Barry Church, preserving the win for Toledo 20-19. And I don't know, Toledo's showing some spunk here in this game. Maybe it'll still come down to a final play.
We get so tired of hearing the coaches talk about the special teams week in and week out, but you see at the end of the game, special teams play was a difference in that ballgame.
Well, there's no question. You know, you look around the country and you see some of the teams like Urban Meyer down there in Florida uses a lot of starters on his special teams unit. What, did Chris Rainey have two blocks last week?
Had two block punts last week. One gave him the ball to three and the other was for a touchdown.
Andrew Elkert with a short kick. Tommy Davis finds a crease. He could go all the way. Touchdown, Tommy Davis. An 83-yard kickoff return.
No flags.
For this Toledo bunch, it's one step forward, two back.
That's really demoralizing to get down the field and do that and talk about the importance of special teams. And there it is right there. What a return by Tommy Davis. He's got some wheels back there as a safety. Normally think of those cornerbacks being the fast guys in the defensive secondary.
And Robert, as you say, there's always a block or two that springs a long return. And watch the combination block right here at the top of the screen. They just dance him right off the dance floor. There wasn't much question that was going the other way for six. What a return.
It was interesting. One of the cover men and the kicker were actually moving in opposite directions there. They kind of ran into each other, you know, as they were going for Davis there. Kind of hurt their chances to tackle him.
Those ladies in the end zone, they have to kick as many times as there are points on the board for Northern Illinois. They've got to make 56 kicks right now.
Yeah, oh, no, you're like not duck.
Yeah, I was going to say, can you imagine if you were the duck up in Eugene at Autzen Stadium?
We did the calculation last week. I should say Wendy Nix did the calculation last week. He's had something like 1,200 push-ups he's had to do this year.
first kickoff return for a touchdown this year for Tommy Davis. The primary punt return man. Kickoff return man.
The duck keeps it up. There's going to be a steroid investigation.
Bernard Reedy on this return. There is a marker down, and so is Reedy at the 15-yard line. Early indications are it's a holding call.
Matt Ng with the tackle for the Huskies.
Holding on the return team. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
Long field for Toledo. Well, Saturday afternoon on ABC and ESPN, Penn State looking to carry the momentum from Joe Paterno's 400th win against a ninth-ranked Ohio State team, inching closer to a possible Rose Bowl berth. Some of you are going to see Texas Tech, Oklahoma, or Virginia Tech, North Carolina. College football presented by Kay Jewelers on ABC or ESPN at 3:30 Eastern. Virginia Tech, they've won 7 in a row, ranked number 20, only undefeated team in the ACC. Who would have thought that? After the first 2 weeks of the season.
Well, especially the second week, but I think that was a bit of a letdown game. The way they had the game essentially won against Boise State, all they have to do is pick up a first down. That was a devastating loss, and that was a tough game. You talk about chemistry coming back the next week, even with the strength of opponent they were facing.
Yeah, 5 days later there, wet field, tough circumstances.
51 combined points in the quarter, but Northern Illinois still has a commanding lead.
ESPN College Football Primetime, South Carolina, Florida, Saturday at 7:15.
What is it?
It's a big, scary.
You're all right.
Wolf Tooth.
Here they come, yo. Here they come. Here they
this
come.
Or that. This or that. This or that. This. You can deal with this, or you can deal with that. Or you can deal with this, or you can deal with that. Or you can deal with this, or you can deal with that.
With DirecTV, you can start watching in one room, pause, and continue watching in any other room. Don't just watch TV. DirecTV.
So tell us your story.
This whole lunch thing was completely out of control, man. I mean, putting a mini blizzard in a meal deal with a double cheeseburger? For just $3.99? It's insanity.
Actually, that sounds pretty good.
I know, it's great.
So why are you here?
I just wanted to hear my voice like this. Deep voice, man.
Lunch will never be the same. The DQ mini blizzard meal deal with a double cheeseburger. Just $3.99 for a limited time.
World of Warcraft Cataclysm. Pre-order now at Warcraft.com. Rated T14.
What makes a house a home?
ESPN.
ESPN, the home court of college hoops.
In the MAC West on the line tonight in Northern Illinois, in great shape going into the fourth quarter. Take a look at this. Guys, we knew that the MAC was an offensive league, but 51 combined points, 380 total yards of offense in that third quarter. Four plays of 50-plus yards. Here's Terrence Owens, the Toledo quarterback, dumping it off short to Morgan Williams. He's got a first down. Here's another big play. And he is out at the 45-yard line.
Eight combined touchdown runs tonight for both of these teams. I'll tell you, makes for long film studies for those defensive players. And you know those defensive coordinators, every time you talk to them, when you have the interviews with those guys, you know they're so intense anyway. They would be very angry with their respective crews tomorrow.
Nice play by Jake Kaufman, the senior from German Valley, Illinois, which is just up the road from this campus here at NIU. They are proud of that young man in his hometown.
And after Williams cracks off that long run, the window closes in a hurry on his next carry. Williams, the more downhill of the two backs. Thomas obviously has had himself a night as the starter.
Bad read there by Terrence Owens. Should have kept that ball. When Kaufman closes like that, you can get to the outside. He should have kept that one.
Owens at second and 10. Wants the deep ball. Just missed hitting Eric Page on the run.
And watching Owens throw the football, he's very mindful of being secure with the ball. He's done a nice job of not turning it over coming into the game. But at times, you know, he's overthrowing balls where he has to allow his wide receiver to make a play. And he's had a couple opportunities, some of them a little bit more room and area to fit the ball into, especially that missed opportunity in the first half on the post route. But you know, as he matures and gets older, he's going to start hitting these throws.
Southpaw, incomplete, well covered. Devon Butler was there, the middle linebacker.
Coverage from five.
Once again, Kaufman getting nice penetration off the right edge from his defensive end position.
And Owens, as you talked about, David, I think as he matures, he sees more live action in actual games, he's going to get better at plays like that right there. Looked like he just got that pass out a little bit late. Didn't really anticipate when the route was going to be open, allow the defenders to get in position.
Tim Beckman saying, why not at this point? Going for it on fourth down and 10. From their own 45. Owens directing traffic downfield, running out of opportunities. Gets away from a tackler and down at the 32. John Brogard drops him for a loss of 14.
Well, he had an open look. Go ahead and roll it, guys. And he just didn't get to his receiver. Take a look right here. He's got a man wide open in a window. And he just doesn't find him. And again, that's going to come with experience. That was a primary route for him, and a nice job by a slot man sitting down in that void. Owens just couldn't get to him.
And look at Broger there on the sideline. Looked like his shoulder's a little bit banged up, but he ran about 60 yards on that play to make the tackle. Relentless. Said, I'm going to chase you this far. I know I'm making the tackle.
Harnish is going to give Jasmine Hopkins his first carry of the night. He's the fourth string tailback for NIU, and he's going to pick up four. what they say about Progar, guys, is he's a redshirt sophomore still figuring out how to play defensive end. Best years are ahead of him. Well, looks like he's not too bad right now as a sophomore. Ricky Kreider is checked back in. As you take a look at Progar. Penalty markers down.
Prior to the snap, false start. Offense, number 70, 5-yard penalty. Repeat, second down.
So the guard, Logan Pegram, as you take a look at the Mac Bowl tie-ins. Little Caesars Bowl in Detroit. GoDaddy.com in Mobile. And a trip to Boise awaits someone in the Mac. The Humanitarian Bowl.
Bring your cold weather gear for that game. And for the Little Caesars Bowl as well. And interesting that the top tie-in game is played in Detroit, same field that the MAC championship game will be played on December 3rd.
Low snap, Harnish hands off for Kreider. And he backs his way to the 25-yard line. Well, Northern Illinois provided something dramatic happening for Toledo, and they come back to win this game. Northern Illinois is going to go to 8-2, 6-0 in the MAC. They're going to be in great shape to win this Western Division. Final two games on the road at Ball State and Eastern Michigan, both winnable games.
Well, if I'm an automatic qualifier conference team, I'm not sure I want to see Northern Illinois in a bowl game. You're liable to get embarrassed by this team.
Yeah, there's no question about that. And they've already beaten Temple, which, as we said, is maybe a prelude to the MAC championship game. Of course, Temple and Ohio playing next week. That should decide the East.
Incomplete for Harnish to bring up fourth down and 5, intended for Nathan Palmer. You look at Harnish there, and he has been outstanding tonight. 149 yards rushing, 162 passing. He has a passing touchdown and a rushing touchdown.
A bit of a decision here, even in a 33-point game. Do you go for it? You try a field goal? Certainly Jerry Kill doesn't want to appear to be running the score up.
This would be a 43-yard attempt for Klimovsky.
You want to get your field goal kicker some work in these situations under live fire.
He leads the MAC with 12 field goals made this year. At the distance, off the upright, did it bounce through? Yes!
Looks like it hit the flag.
It's been one of those nights for Northern Illinois. Everything going their way. Klimovsky, before this season, he had never attempted a field goal. And how about that one? That's his 13th of the year.
Long before a Cummins diesel engine powered a Ram truck, it roared to life out here and proved itself. Here, here, and here. And is only available in a pickup under here. The Ram 5-year 100,000-mile warranty covers you everywhere. Ram.
With Orbitz, I know what to expect from my vacation. Bad dog balloon pop. Because Orbitz has price assurance. Leaf and face, Marie, man with computer. If another Orbitz customer books the same hotel or flight for less, they'll send me a check for the difference automatically. So I know I'll get their lowest price. And I like knowing what to expect. Bike, unrealistic splash, embarrassingly transparent.
When you Orbitz, you know.
Hi, I'm Ray Lewis. Women want me, men want to be me, and animals want to learn how to talk so they can hang out with me. Do you want to know why?
Why?
Old Spice Showtime deodorant.
That makes sense.
How about the taste of a barbie on the beach this holiday? Come on into Outback and try our special sirloin served with our freshly grilled lobster tails. It's here for a limited time at just $14.95. And purchase $100 in gift cards, get a $20 bonus card free. It's always fresh in the Outback.
You are out with friends. There's Jason. Wait, is that... That's Dave, and that's the Forbidden Dance. And you aren't about to keep it all to yourself. You've got an eye for detail. The Droid Incredible by HTC. Exclusively at Verizon.
These are men who honor the impossible road to victory. And this is indeed the road they will take. Because it's racing.
The Cobalt Tools 500 at Phoenix. Sunday at 3 Eastern on ESPN.
The Roads. Fiesta. Sugar and the Tostitos BCS National Championship Game. ESPN, the BCS lives here.
It only counts as 3 points, but maybe Michael Klobowski should get some style points for that field goal moments ago off the upright. Here's a guy who handled kickoffs for 3 years at Illinois before transferring here to Northern Illinois to study law. And that was his 13th field goal made of the year, which leads the MAC. For the season, he had never attempted a field goal. He was just the kickoff guy for the Illini.
Never doubt that one was going to go through the uprights.
not with that body English he put on it.
And this one he squibs. Fielded at the 17-yard line by Reedy. Let's take a look at the BCS standings presented by Discover Card. And Oregon for the second straight week, the number one team in the country. They've got a game at Cal this weekend. Auburn, 10-0. TCU, that impressive win over Utah, firmly at number three, and there's Boise at four.
Well, Robert, what's interesting to me here, and I know a lot of people are saying, hey, there's not a one-loss team that could jump ahead of a TCU or a Boise State, but if there was, I don't think it would be an LSU. I think Stanford is playing red hot right now, and I don't think they're getting enough credit from people. You know, with Andrew Luck at quarterback and the way they're playing on offense,
the problem for Stanford is they've already played Oregon, and there's really nobody left. They played Oregon and USC. There's really nobody left on their schedule that would give them that kind of boost, in my opinion. Of course, LSU sitting there at 8-1 should be 7-2. I mean, Tennessee, if they could count, if they could count personnel, then that game would have been lost.
Second down at 6. Terrence Owens. His first career start. He's had some shining moments, but for the most part, it's been a tough go. Pump fake goes over the middle of the field. This time, in and out of the hands of Eric Page. Well covered in the secondary, too, by Garrett Barnes. We have seen Owens overthrow some receivers tonight. He was right on target there, but ends up incomplete.
Yeah, this is an impressive throw. And he takes a little bit off the ball, gets it up with nice timing. He sees a DB trailing the play blind, and he drops it right on the numbers.
That really was a nice throw. Barnes is lucky he didn't get a flag on that one. Sometimes you can get flags for face guarding. You don't turn around to play the ball and just get your arms up.
And he's going to stop well short of the first down marker. And they have converted just two times tonight on third down.
Well, the good news is Terrence Owens has showed us the ability to hit all the throws. I mean, there's no doubt he can hit all the throws and attack all the areas on the field. It's just that, you know, he's had some open receivers down the field. He's overthrown them. That was the big post route we just saw in the first half that would have made it a 14-7 game. But, I mean, he can make all of them. He has the arm talent to play the position.
What does it say to you as a former quarterback that it's consistently overthrows?
Tommy Davis has a kickoff return for a touchdown. This punt, he's going to let it roll into the end zone.
He's a young quarterback. It's a big game. I think he's got a lot of adrenaline. You know, he's hyped up, and he had some big throws early, and now he's geared down the second half, and he's been more accurate.
Northern Illinois gets the ball back, leading huge when we come back.
How can rice production in India affect wheat output in the U.S.? the shipping industry in Norway, and the rubber industry in South America. At T. Rowe Price, we understand the connections of a complex global economy. It's just one reason over 75% of our mutual funds beat their 10-year Lipper average. T. Rowe Price. Invest with confidence. Request a prospectus or summary prospectus with investment objectives, risks, fees, expenses, and other information to read and consider carefully before investing.
Long before a Hemi engine powered a Ram truck, it was born up here. Tested down here. And proven beyond a doubt out here. And is only available in a pickup under here. A Ram 5-year, 100,000-mile warranty covers you everywhere. Ram.
Steve Spurrier leads South Carolina against the Gators for a spot in the SEC Championship game. South Carolina, Florida, Saturday at 7:15 on ESPN.
Saturday, November 13th, the fight of the year is on. Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao looking to make history and become the sport's first 8-time 8-division world champion. Standing in his way is the biggest and most dangerous opponent yet, Antonio Margarito. Order now, and with the purchase of a 12-pack of Tecate or Tecate Light, receive up to $25 back by mail. Offer ends November 13th, 2010. Must be 21 years of age or older. Other terms apply. Pacquiao versus Margarito. Live Saturday, November 13th on DirecTV Pay-Per-View.
I know it will be painful, but 6 months, a year from now, it'll all blow over. I am not looking to destroy you.
DirecTV gives you the best TV benefits.
I live for the 101 Network. They have my favorite dramas and show them the way I like them. Uncut and commercial-free, I just tuned to channel 101.
You've got the benefits of the best TV, DirecTV.
ESPN's College Football Primetime, brought to you by T. Rowe Price. Understanding the connections of today's complex global economy. Invest with confidence.
Back here in DeKalb, Illinois, where the Huskies of NIU have a commanding 59-23 lead. Just over 9 minutes to go. Good run for the backup quarterback, Jordan Lynch. And it's been an impressive game on the ground for NIU. Robert Smith, David Norrie, I'm Clay Matvick back here in DeKalb. And guys, as we look ahead to the week in college football, what game stands out to you and which one are you looking most forward to?
Well, I think Florida, South Carolina. You know, this Florida team struggled so mightily at the beginning of the season. I mean, the way they looked against Miami of Ohio, South Florida, we really were wondering if this team would ever turn it around. Finally got some guys back healthy, Rainey off the suspension. South Carolina, terrible game last week. So this is going to be for the SEC East. I'm interested to see how that one plays out.
What stands out for you, David?
Well, I think that Georgia-Auburn game is going to be a very interesting game. I think that the distractions that are being created by the Cam Newton situation are not only going to play into Cam Newton's psyche down the stretch, but also the rest of the team. And they've got a big, big schedule to take care of going into perhaps an SEC championship game. But to play Auburn down the stretch, and Georgia's dangerous. Aaron Murray is a very talented young quarterback. So I'm actually going to be covering that game on national radio for ESPN this week, and I'm very interested to see how they react in that environment. And I think Georgia is no gimme in that game by any means.
And once they got A.J. Green back into their lineup, they really turned around with their confidence, and it looked a lot better.
Well, there's another run for Jordan Lynch. On another national note, Colorado has made a coaching change as they fired their head coach. Dan Hawkins is the second notable coaching casualty following Tim Brewster at Minnesota to get the axe here this year.
What about Todd Dodge down there in North Texas?
Yep.
Not as notable. I didn't hear about it until last week, actually. But that's going to be that's an interesting one for me. But yeah, it's Colorado. I've heard some interesting names being thrown around as possibilities for that opening.
Yeah, no doubt in my mind, in my opinion, that Oregon deserves that number one spot right now.
Handoff here, another first down for Northern Illinois. Jasmine Hopkins picks it up.
And being an Oregonian, being a native Oregonian, it kind of warms my heart, Robert.
Wait a second. You're from Oregon? I didn't know you were from Oregon. No wonder you've been spouting off about Oregon so much.
I mean, anybody could spout off about Oregon right now. That offense is a machine right now.
The defense isn't a machine, although they've outscored opponents 87-7 in the fourth quarters this year. You know, teams have been down so much. Stanford really surprised me the way they played them in the second half. Got away from the run. Of course, Owusu got the concussion, and that hurt them as well. Interception on the same play.
And no gain here for Northern Illinois' Jasmine Hopkins. You guys have been talking about Oregon. How about Auburn? You poke a hole in Oregon saying, you know, they give up a lot of points. What about Auburn? What's a shortfall in the Tigers game?
Same thing. Defensively, they've given up way too many yards. You know, you look back at that Arkansas game, they got in a shootout, and it was Tyler Wilson, the backup for Ryan Mallett, that threw all over that Auburn secondary. They're really weak in the secondary. Have you called any of their games this
no,
year, David?
No, I haven't, but I've seen plenty of them. And, you know, the one thing I can say is when they do give up yards and games get tight, Cam Newton gets better.
It's amazing.
Here's Jordan Lynch. He's be dropped for a loss. Jordan Lynch had a 90-yard touchdown run against Buffalo earlier this year. SEC showdown Saturday night. We're talking about it. Here's proof that it's going to happen again. Number 23, South Carolina. Number 22, Florida. As Steve Spurrier goes back into the swamp. And this is for the SEC East title. College football primetime presented by Hampton Hotel Saturday at 7:15 Eastern.
Hard to believe. Florida a couple weeks ago was on a three-game losing skid in the SEC. Hard to believe they're playing to get into the title game. And you know, with Brantley and Burton alternating at quarterback, they found their stride.
Lynch steps up. And it'll be stopped at the 44.
And while Burton, Robert, comes in and he plays kind of the wildcat quarterback position, Brantley's the passer, obviously. They've become a two-dimensional team. And then you have Jordan Reed, a guy who really is listed as a tight end, but he came in last week. I was down at Vanderbilt. He came into that game, and he played three or four possessions at the end of that game. He's big. He can throw the ball. He can run. I think Jordan Reed is the future quarterback at Florida, and Urban Meyer has everything he needs in that type of athlete.
Josh Wilbur, the first punt of the night for Northern Illinois. And a couple of days before Veterans Day, Wilbur, a former Marine, puts Toledo inside the 20-yard line. We're back in a bit.
AT&T introduces a new Windows phone with beauty and brains. A phone that gets you to the stuff you love faster. Only from AT&T. Rethink possible.
Taco Bell, new Double XL Chalupa. Double the beef, loads of nacho cheese sauce and tons of toppings and a monster chalupa shell. It's so big, you better call in a closer.
Don't worry, kid. I got it. Go get him, Mo.
Nope. Think outside the bun.
Beat your worst flu symptoms. New Theraflu Max D contains the most powerful medicine allowable without a prescription to fight your worst flu symptoms. Theraflu Max D, serious power.
Boom, boom, boom. Check yourself before you wreck yourself.
Bang, 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 bang.
Why are your father's ashes in a coffee can?
Because he's dead, Peter.
Dude,
Dad, you're like a father to me.
Rated R.
Many will hear the calling.
Move it!
Yes, sir!
Few will earn the title United States Marine. For few, the proud Marines.
The Hemi and Cummins engines that took on all comers here. Never took a day off here. Raised the bar out here.
and help get the job done here are only available in a pickup under here. The Ram 5-year, 100,000-mile warranty covers you everywhere. Ram.
All right, let's take a look at our coverage spotlight brought to you by Travelers. And the game was still, I guess, in doubt. It was a 19-point difference, but Toledo was definitely taking over the momentum, and that's when there was a big interception by Rashawn Melvin. Really took the game right back for Northern Illinois.
You know, that's one of those young mistakes that we have been talking about from Terrence Owens. I want to try and take a shot, but don't just let that thing float up there. Didn't quite get the proper trajectory on there. Allowed the safety help to get over.
There's Morgan Williams out of the backfield making the catch. That was the first career interception thrown by Terrence Owens, again making his first career start tonight. A lot on his plate. The redshirt freshman out of Cleveland starting in place of the injured Austin Banton. And he was going to be up against it on the road here at a very good Northern Illinois team.
I think this is a great kind of environment, to tell you the truth, to break in a young quarterback. I would have thought the way that Garrett Gilbert got thrown in the fire in the championship game, he would have played a lot better this year. But, you know, you get a young guy on the road like this, first career start, learn a lot.
Well, and I think he's really represented himself well in this game. You know, he's missed a couple throws, but he's proven that he can make all the different kinds of throws. He's been poised. You know, he's not making a bunch of risky plays where he's, you know, putting his team in jeopardy. You talk about turnovers. I think he's going to be one of the real bright stars of the future in this conference.
They've had some bright stars at quarterback in this conference.
Here he is on third and five, incomplete. Big hit in the secondary as Jimmy Ward's throwing his body around.
Well, that one should have been a penalty. That was a helmet-to-helmet hit there. That was pretty bad. He's fortunate that they don't levy $50,000 fines in college football.
Well, and this was a ball from Owens that, if he just gets the ball out a little sooner, he's going to catch his receiver in the void. And
I just hate to see that.
Yeah, well, it's a dangerous play.
Jasmine Hopkins back to return this punt. He's not going to get an opportunity. And bounces out of bounds at the 37-yard line. Now here's our Dodge Ram drive recap. And it's not just one drive, several drives tonight for Northern Illinois. Very impressive. 8 total explosion plays. That means 20 yards or more.
As we said earlier, it's going to be a long film study day. You can't really have those kind of long runs without some major breakdowns defensively. And I think both of these teams have really had some major breakdowns, some technique issues, but some explosive players as well on the other side.
And it's very rare that you get that many explosion plays when your offensive line isn't dominant. And that's been the case. Northern Illinois has played so well up front. You got to give a lot of credit to this offensive line.
Hopkins making his way up the middle and down at the 45-yard line. An 8-yard pickup for Jasmine Hopkins. College football primetime continuing on ESPN and ESPN2. Thursday night, 7:30 Eastern on ESPN. Pitt taking on UConn. Pitt trying to get a Big East BCS bid. Then on ESPN2, Friday at 9 Eastern, Kellen Moore and 4th-ranked Boise State against Idaho. College football on ESPN Thursday and ESPN2 Friday. That Boise State-Idaho series that used to be dominated by Idaho. Boy, things have changed over the years.
When you look at Pittsburgh, you know, with all respects, the BCS game that gets the Big East team is not going to be real excited about their matchup.
Hopkins showing what he can do. Goodbye, Jasmine Hopkins, a 55-yard touchdown run. Everybody contributing tonight for Northern Illinois.
I think they're just worn out defensively at Toledo. I mean, this is like summer conditioning, except it's cold out. I mean, you're running sprints up and down the field all night long, chasing these guys around. Where's you out?
Yeah, you got a bunch of 300-pounders leaning on you all night if you're the defensive front, and the way that Northern Illinois has gone up and down the field, hard not to be totally gassed. And this defense is.
Klamovsky misses the extra point. So the ladies in the end zone were getting ready to do 66 kicks. They get a break. They only have to do 65.
And I just hope that all of them realize that the extra point was missed.
Northern Illinois is going to go to 6-0 in the MAC. Their seventh straight win. This is their best start since 2004. They've clinched bowl eligibility. They've already done that before the night started. It's going to be the third year in a row that Northern Illinois will be going to a bowl game.
That's a great achievement for Jerry Kill and Toledo, already bowl eligible. You know, there's a lot of talk about not enough bowl eligible teams with six wins, and you know, the NCAA is going to have to address that. They may have to let some 5 and 7 teams into the bowl picture.
Well, there could be some teams coming out of the Sun Belt that would qualify as well, though. Some pretty good teams down in the Sun Belt.
Northern Illinois with a season high 584 total yards, as they're going to need some Ben Gay, or I hope some of those ladies have been using the Suzanne Summers exercise equipment. Big run for Bernard Reedy. Not close to midfield, a 30-yard return for Reedy. College football games this week on the ESPN family of networks in the MAC. Miami and Bowling Green. That's tomorrow night. And we talked about Pitt and UConn. Ball State and Buffalo over on the U, and then Boise and Idaho.
It always seems that Boise State has a tough game against a team that they should really take care of year in and year out. And I know this is a different team, and Kellen Moore is Kellen Moore, but you know, you don't chalk up a win automatically when Boise State has to go into Idaho.
Well, Idaho's been a bit of a disappointment after the way that they played last year.
Terrence Owens drops it off underneath. It's a 4-yard pickup for David Pasquale, who's actually the number 3 quarterback as well. Pretty good runner, pretty good receiver. They use him in a lot of scenarios. Clock moving, 1:10 to go. Owens, incomplete. Tim Beckman, the head coach of Toledo, went with the rookie quarterback tonight. And how is he going to assess his redshirt freshman?
I think there are a lot of bright spots and a lot of good things that Terrence Owens is going to take out of this game, and his coaching staff is going to take out of the game when they evaluate him. And that's the reason why he's still in this game. 65-23, they want to get him as much live action as they can.
And it's such a different experience to be out on the field with the live action. I know the game's out of reach right now, but it means so much, and you grow so much as a player the more you see live plays.
And the way he flashes that ball outside there, putting the ball on Daniels, you know, it's very evident to me that he can do all the things as a pass run threat, the spread quarterback at this level. He has the complete toolbox.
Toledo has games against Bowling Green and Central Michigan left on their schedule. This one inside the 20-yard line, complete from Owens to Reedy.
You can just feel him settling down on some of these throws, Robert. Some of the throws that were more difficult for him early, he's starting to feel the timing and the rhythm on.
Trying to end this game on a positive note, they hand off to David Pasquale. Short pickup. Clock continues to run. 30 seconds to play.
It's kind of like making the putt after it's already been given to you, though. You know, it's a little bit like that, but I think definitely he definitely is feeling more comfortable. But the heat's definitely not on him right now either.
It's
a lot to grow on.
That was a pretty throw right there, and we're going to rule that a catch.
Complete to James Green.
There are some quarterbacks at the college level that can't make that throw, put it on a spot with a couple extra revolutions on the ball, some extra velocity.
As we said earlier, this is a young team, especially offensively. Only two starters on this offense are seniors, and 18 out of the 44 in the two deep on both sides of the ball are either freshmen or sophomores. So Tim Beckman's done an excellent job. This only his second year.
Did he keep his feet in? No, he did not. Incomplete.
That is ruled incomplete.
The tight end Jerome Jones ruled out.
Like that right heel looked like it was on the line. Oh, yeah.
Well, and Jones is going to be thinking about that tonight more than once. You know, that the footwork is something that you work on day in and day out, and that was an opportunity for a touchdown, a well-thrown ball, another well-thrown ball from Owens.
8 seconds to play. Owens looking toward the end zone again, flushed out, has a man caught. Touchdown Toledo, Jerome Jones. This time, no doubt about it, he's in, but there is a marker down.
Oh, no, don't take it away from him.
He was going to be able to forget about his footwork on that previous play.
To the Jones.
Yep. Offensive linemen are coming off the field. Nope. Yeah, looks like the kicking unit's coming out. They know something we don't know.
Well, there have been 7 penalties tonight on Toledo. They don't want one here to wipe out their touchdown with a few seconds left.
The result of the play is a touchdown. Afterwards, personal foul. Offense. Number 69, late hit. The penalty will be enforced on the kickoff.
So Kevin Kowalski, the Toledo center.
4-year starter, and it looked like Jerry Kill, Northern Illinois head coach, was not very excited about it.
And the extra point for Klaus is good.
Your score, Northern Illinois 69, Toledo 30.
That look right there from Tim Beckman pretty much says it all.
Now this is a nice drive, even though this game has long been over. We saw an array of throws and different looks for Terrence Owens, and it's about as good as he's looked throwing the football tonight.
This is Jake Kaufman, 26-year-old Marine, served a couple of tours in Iraq. Great American, and he is celebrating with his team a big win in the MAC West tonight as Northern Illinois goes to 6-0. They're the only undefeated team left now in the MAC, and they are in the driver's seat to win the West. They would really have to let down in the final 2 weeks not to win the West and get a berth in the MAC championship game. What a job Jerry Kill has done in his third year here as head coach. He's still fired up over that call.
Well, I think he's fired up about getting 11 players on his return team out on the field. Yeah, he's coaching his team hard in terms of just personnel decisions and getting everybody out on the field and fielding a team here with 3 seconds to go.
Northern Illinois tonight. 70 plays, 584 yards, that's a season high. 422 of those yards on the ground, and 65 points, also a season high.
That's a track meet.
What a way for the seniors to go out. 21 seniors for Northern Illinois playing their final home game tonight. And Toledo has been a tough opponent over the years. The Rockets have come in here in the past and knocked the Huskies around. Not tonight. This is the most points they've ever scored in their series against the Rockets. And Jerry Kill, very proud of the job that Chandler Harnish did tonight.
When you have a quarterback playing at that level with an offensive line that's doing the work that they're doing up front, this is going to be a tough team to beat down the stretch.
It really has. All year long, these guys have been tough. But I've got to say, Tim Beckman and Toledo, a lot of bright things ahead for these guys. They're a very young team, and they'll definitely be in the mix for years to come.
So that's going to do it. Once again, our final score, Northern Illinois 65, Toledo 30. Don't forget, tomorrow night at 8 Eastern, College Football Primetime has more from the MAC as Miami takes on Bowling Green. Coming up next, NBA Coast to Coast. For David Norrie and Robert Smith, I'm Clay Manfin. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports, saying so long from DeKalb, Illinois.
NBA Coast to Coast. Miami's trio tries to stay in tune against the Jazz. What Paul Millsap did to spoil those plans. Sweet music back on the Bayou. We'll see if Chris Paul and the Hornets could stay perfect. And we'll go live to Staples Center to check in on the maestro Kobe and the perfect Lakers against Minnesota. Coast to Coast is next.
Welcome to NBA Coast to Coast.
You may never have seen anything like it before, and you may never see anything like it again. The Indiana Pacers scored 54 points in the third quarter tonight against the Nuggets.